the realm that I'm in. I could break the necks of every single man. My strategy is strategically pushed inside of my hands from the motherlands. While I could still speak Swahili, feeling nervous about concealing feet dancing on the ceiling. I done channeled Lionel Richie. Feel my final while you bitchin'. Feel my final while you bitchin'. Plus my palm is itching. Money is the symptom, and I'm screaming fuck the system. Catastrophic cataclysms, and they tell us mind our business. But I'm busy with my business. You don't shut the f- I say peace, God. On my.
You weren't supposed to stop it. You were supposed to let me gently fade it out into the background. I get it. This is what, the fourth show? Third show?
Okay, this gotta be. I was like, this is weird. The she's first she's 10.
Hi, it's Breasts and Thighs. I am the Henry Panic's replacement.
Right? I'm Allie.
I'm AJ, a.k.a. Bar Guy, a.k.a. That Guy, a.k.a. the host with the most.
Boom.
That's right. And I'm the man with a few tricks up his sleeve.
There you go. All right. So, what do you got for us?
Oh, fuck. Sorry. Nothing? I was sitting on my watch party.
There you go.
Let me
turn this down.
I'm honestly just going to give it to him because I can't even describe you.
Man. Oh.
So tell everybody about the people that mm-hmm. are the new listeners who don't know anything about you. Tell us who you are.
Started off as a traveling artist, nomad, just a freestyler that liked to get crowds and dance and put on a show and host shows. And now I'm actually like an artist that's recording and making videos. So, yeah, taking my time. I started off doing poetry on HBO, and so now I'm like taking rap series.
How far did you get with the HBO stuff? Was it like a series or?
Yeah, we're like, you could like look me up on YouTube, or they actually still play us on HBO, but who still has cable? But yeah, when they play Brave New Voices, I'm Hampton Roads youth team. That's me. Like on
dope.
There. With no hair, baby face, shawty.
That's dope.
Yeah.
That is dope, man. I remember running into you like years ago. It was like, damn, this dude right here just could spit. He had talent coming out every angle of his being, man. And just rapping, just out, just cold flow, just coming out of nowhere, man. I think we were at like Ybor City someplace.
Yeah, random bars.
Random bars, yeah.
That's how I
was
didn't
that
know
back
about.
In the Lion's Den days or?
Probably right around that time, yeah. We were around that time, and we would pop in at Rez just randomly, and I'd just see him battle and just
killing
dudes left and right. Just like nobody could really hang with him like that. And the ones that did were pretty dope as well. But I mean, just he has his own star. It shines, you know, brightly, you know.
I hear you've been shooting some new music videos too, stuff like that.
Yeah, I've been working on some new projects, trying to get this new EP out. Already got the name for it, Bar Guy for President. Yeah, trying to drop that soon.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, that's dope, man.
Yeah, got some a couple things.
How long you been making music?
I guess solidified. I've been traveling making music. Like, the sad thing about my career is before I took it serious, when I say I travel, so picture traveling the world, you freestyle to some people, and they like, I want you on my mixtape. So I'm on Apple Music, on other people's albums, like for
Are
years.
You getting any royalties from that? Or
like, no, like they not even getting paid or really that much, but I didn't care at that time. Like, I
what
don't
about
really,
like BMI and shit like that? Are you
I been... didn't even care about all that. My name is on there, but I just be traveling the world and they think it's dope. And the fact that my voice on there, it'd be different if they took my voice and kept my bars and somebody did that. But it's like traveling the world, I'm on everybody's mixtape. So then I just started my own thing when I came to Florida.
How much product you got?
Product, good product, like hot cocaine product, literally like a good 5.
Like songs or talking about like albums?
Like
total album, like say somebody comes up to you, how many albums you got? How many?
Okay, so 2 mixtape and 1 EP.
Okay.
Yeah.
Who's the producer on the majority of it?
I had a manager back in VA, so I got my guy Dreams. He works on that back then. That's who got Peace God. Peace God is actually very old. Just shot a video to it down here. And I like that's when I knew myself.
I love seeing all the Ybor City landmarks and that. That was pretty fucking dope.
Yeah, that was fun to see.
What alley was that?
That's behind Rez.
I was looking for like specific graffiti and shit that I know from different bars, but it was too quick of a thing. I couldn't figure it out.
Oh yeah, it's right there behind Rez and that the blowtorch shop, the little.
Hot wax.
Yeah, it's like between those two.
Say it. Why you say
with that
face? Of course,
it just gets brought up every fucking show.
Why you say it with that face?
Every fucking show. That's one of the stories.
You don't like that place?
I love the place.
Oh, okay.
Bob Dylan's my guy.
Hell, you funny.
Speaking of that, he just fucking texted me, so that's funny.
Did you shout out your boy today?
You were hilarious.
Oh, no, because we're already talking about the ginger, so I can't just shout out Big Dick Bob for no reason.
Why not? That's just, hey, create heat in the streets. That's all I'm saying.
Heat in the streets.
There's enough of that shit.
Big that shit facts. Was funny with the bike, though. You were just like, I can't even repeat what you said.
Just say it.
We were sitting there just having a drink, and where were we at? White Lie. And then you seen him, and you was just like, we talking about some dude.
Oh, we were talking. Yeah, we were talking, and old boy came by on his bike, and I'm like, fuck you. And then I just went right back to my conversation with him.
Did you know him?
Yeah, he's my ex.
Oh, okay. Oh.
He works at the blowtorch shop.
Yeah, that's why she's
not Glob a fan.
Oh, Glob Dylan.
Cool. Glob Dylan, my nigga. Hey.
That dude's cool. Everybody
that's
in
a
here,
small world. It's okay.
Allie, everybody in here like him but you.
Everybody. I thought he was a good guy.
Nah, he's a cool dude.
I liked him.
Anyway. I wanted to know, how did you get your passion for what you do? How did you jump into what you do, BarGod?
I started, you know, believe it or not, I started out dancing. Like, I've always been in front of a crowd.
Okay.
So I did the talent shows. Since I'm a military brat.
What branch?
My parents were Navy.
Okay.
They were in George Washington. So since I'm going in and out the country, they had this one time where the kids get together, and now we're all on TV because we got to sing for these solos. And then this is when I thought I was the ish. This is before I'm the ish. I got a head ahead of myself. So they gave me, because I'm articulate with words, they gave me a speaking point. You know what I'm saying? So there's going to be a break where they sing. I sing. I mean, I talk, right?
Yeah.
And then I talk, and then somebody sings, and then I come back. The solo was did so good on the second part. When it was supposed to bounce back to rap, the little talking, the singing, I tried to take the mic, look, and try to hit that note.
Oh.
You got the people down there that's recording, like, don't stop it. Back up. So I started there, and then Mario came out with Just a Friend, and then I started dancing, putting the talent show together, and I started making fun of Lil Wayne in the lunch hall, being a nerd, because I was fat with cornrows, and they was picking on me, and they said, you can't rap, and boom, from there.
So in school?
Yes, literally in school.
What grade was this?
Hey, there's no sound
like
from
sixth
your
grade.
From your thing.
When you said that, it reminded me of that scene from Coming to America when he was like, Randy Watson! He just took the microphone and came out there. But you actually, you did it up. You basically stole the show for real.
Yeah, after I found out I was singing.
How can
it
be live?
Early in the game.
That's impossible what he just said.
Well, I don't care.
Because you shared my link.
He said it. He said there's no video from, or there's no audio from your post, but there's audio on mine. And he says, move that pretty girl into Henry's seat.
He said he wants the pretty girl in your seat.
That's what he said. I have it on the post.
What, we got like a 15-second delay or something?
Yeah, it's about 30.
Oh, okay.
Do you hear that? What's that? What do you hear?
It's audio.
Hey, Henry, what do you hear? Matter of fact, let me turn the music down so you can hear it. Hey, Henry, what do you hear in the background? That's the sound of the show coming from the TV. So turn your volume up on your phone.
Motherfucker.
He got his phone on me talking about y'all ain't got
stop
no
stop playing with me. I ain't
y'all
got
ain't
no sound
around here in these
you don't know what you talking about, son. I've been doing this.
Can we
put your hearing aid back in, man?
I need shots. We need shots.
Hold up. Thank you. Good idea.
I'm not drinking.
I'm ready now. Because I was scared. I was like, damn, I fucked up. Nobody's hearing me.
I was pacing.
So how'd you come up with your name?
I was going to ask you that.
That one was...
Yelly.
I was...
Wow. You hear this? Just you hear this?
Hey, that was perfect.
You're wow. Late. Okay.
You're late. So, actually, I didn't, for some long time, I didn't have a name. And I was just out here making stuff up as I go. And it was going to be some corny stuff like Double Eye, which I still might go with.
That's not bad, though. Double Eye ain't bad.
Double Eye was going to be for ignorance and intelligence. Because I use a whole bunch of big words. But all I talk about is pussy. You know what I'm saying?
Ain't no wrong with that.
It sounds real good and extravagant. But it's pussy. You know what I'm saying? Pussy.
Immaculate pussy.
Our first two episodes, all we talked about was sex. So.
Yeah, that's but that's it. That's like
ain't
my
wrong with that.
Thing,
we all love it.
Nah, we all do. We all love it. Ain't nothing wrong with that.
I posted a meme.
Sometimes we love it by ourselves.
I'm embarrassed about the number of guys I've slept with, but the quality of them.
That is actually really real.
Yeah, I'll tell you.
Yeah,
I'm a vodka girl.
But yeah, I went. I got like a manager who recorded me going live on her thing, and we actually went viral in Virginia, like 20,000 in a couple of hours. And my manager would just say, "BarGod, salute everybody,
salute."
That was Virginia Beach, right? Or Norfolk?
Nazarol, yeah.
Around that same area, Virginia Beach, Norfolk area.
I miss VA.
Yeah, I miss it too. Even though the bars
down there were ridiculous.
What part of Virginia was it?
I lived on 21st and Mediterranean in Virginia Beach. They had like the best happy hour ever from 5 to 7 or some shit like that.
Look, I wasn't a drinker until
$1.50 anything behind the bar.
Oh, wow.
Get a Long Island for $1.50. Sure, so we'd order like 18 drinks because we'd get there with like 10 minutes to spare. Okay. And our tables would just be filled with fucking drinks for the rest of the night.
Oh, my God. Sound
like danger.
It was.
For real.
Danger.
Virginia Beach is alcohol poisoning city.
That's the first place to take a date.
I know there's a lot of nice people there. I remember I seen like a family of white folks enjoying their food, and they had just got this one pizza, and I'm like walking by with a friend just looking at the pizza. They took the husband like took a slice out, boxed the pizza, and gave me and my friend like the rest of it.
Wow.
Yeah, that's that military state. That's the Commonwealth for that ass.
Yeah, that's true. All though right. That's true though. So you went to high school and stuff out there?
Yeah, high school. I always qualify where you're from where you graduated. And I graduated in Virginia. That's the simplest term if you ask me everything else.
So it wasn't all 4 years there then?
No, it was all 4 years in high school. That's the middle school and elementary and anything below that that like going back and forth.
Okay. You still keep in touch with anybody from back then or not?
Oh, yeah, yeah. I got to because that's like the ride or die. They just now starting to boom anyway. Like, yeah. I was in a nonprofit down there. I got to.
Those venues out there were so much better, I think, than the venues we have here.
I don't know, man. It's kind of like what you said about sex. It's that quality thing.
It's the quality.
They may have the cheap drinks, but are the people there to make the establishments dope? Because I left Virginia for what my friend said I needed, a metropolitan area. Like, where people were just more active and people a little bit more wild or more receptive.
Right.
It's
right.
Beautiful out here.
Right. I kind of dealt with that when I left Portland, Oregon. I mean, in Oregon, you had it was a beautiful place to live, but it was also one of the most racist cities I've ever lived in.
Really?
Oregon,
yes,
scorn
yes,
to
indeed.
Oregon.
It's
is
very,
that where you grew up? Or?
I grew up 23 years there, but it's different here. I moved here in 2006, and I love it in Tampa like quite a bit. You know, more we have a lot more opportunity, we have a lot more variety. We got, you know, it's kind of the city's kind of spread out, so you have a lot to see and do. And depending on what kind of group you roll with, you could change your energy. You know,
yeah, absolutely.
If you're at the beach, or you got a group that goes to Miami, you got a group that goes to, you know, Universal or Disney or whatever, you know, Ybor. You got that going on. Ybor, those are my people.
Well, and Tampa's got some of the best artists, musicians nationwide. Like, I've been a lot of places, and there's a lot of artists here that can make it in any state. So,
absolutely,
we're definitely in a good spot. We just need to get a few things adjusted to where everybody moves as a unit. Because right now, I ain't doing
Can
that.
It's starting. Y'all need to get the fuck out of y'all hometown.
That's fact. Oh, yeah. No, that's exactly what I'm telling a lot of people.
Well,
you got
to
go.
Place to simmer. It's a good place to
here?
Simmer.
Yeah.
No, don't even simmer. You can simmer
up to a boil. You know, you can get
it. Here.
Well, Tampa Bay is the sixth largest market in the United States. So it's a very good location to be as far as to get out of there, but as far as local support, you don't get it much.
Not much.
Not until you not go much. Out somewhere and then come back.
You got to have a couple people around you here that can go out of their way to help you.
Look
you know
at Shock G. He's going to open mics now.
Yeah.
Yeah. You got to have a group around you that can go out of their way. I mean, you know. That's
you got to have the right team, too. Yeah, it's like it takes a lot, especially because I've been in the music scene since 2008, and it's changed a lot since from where it was to where it is now. Back then, nobody messed with anybody. Now it's starting to get more unified, like behind people like Fresh P and J-Rock Jones, people like that, Tom G. Mm. But you really don't get that full force behind a lot of guys.
Yeah.
So it's just taking time. Guy. You know, you got
a little bit of time. Yeah,
people got to put in their work, and then the real people recognize who the real talented ones are and who the ones that are just doing it just to do it. So it's coming along though.
I'm just afraid, like, with this fucking coronavirus bullshit, that the music industry is gonna fucking die.
It's taking a hit. No, it's not. It's not gonna die because the creativity has stepped up more than anything.
I feel it's gonna open up a little bit.
Yeah,
I mean, but they did a whole concert on Fortnite, and 6ix9ine is getting $5 million to do a live stream. Listen,
dudes are getting real creative.
We good.
But what about what about the local artists?
Then it's up to all these
like,
local
artists. I got lucky being able to get a venue this past Saturday to have a show. I had 2 weeks to promote that show. Busted my ass. Everybody came, had a great time, wore their masks, you know, bought their drinks to go, that sort of thing. It was cool. Great time, no problems. And then the next day, it's all shit talk. Oh, you shouldn't, not from the people that were there, but from the people that didn't.
Oh, that's always going to happen.
Talking about,
though, I mean, you know,
you shouldn't have had a show during the pandemic, this, that, the other.
Well, a lot of that is
go
from
fuck
people,
yourself.
A lot of that is from people who want to do shows that don't.
Oh, well, I'm sorry that you're a shitty promoter
jealousy
and nobody wants to work with you.
Yeah, yeah.
Exactly.
You got to be independent of the good opinion of other people. You know what I'm saying? Not everybody's going to like everything you do, but you got to do it anyway. You got to let yourself shine no matter what.
Or give no fucks. You have options.
Yeah. Absolutely zero fucks.
It's me. That was my clean version. Yeah, that was the
thing. Exactly. He was being more professional about it.
No fucks given.
Big facts. See? Yo. And you wouldn't be able to say that on FM.
I can say that artist.
They would be fine.
I can say that now. Yeah. What the problem is you got to go out your way to go make
hit that button. Like, wait,
is he going? Is too he going to do it?
Too late.
Yeah,
it's over already.
What was your first single? Not even that. What was the first song you wrote? First verse you wrote? Do you remember it?
No, I don't. Man,
you don't remember the first verse you wrote?
It was court. It was high school stuff.
Exactly,
bro.
But still.
Oh man,
come on, you gotta remember. Think about
it. I had some freaky song called Flashlight or something. Don't listen. It was because I was a singer back then. I was in chorus and everything. I did all of that stuff. So I was writing R&B songs. I had a group. I was like the leader of my own dance crew.
What was it called? What was the crew called?
Man, listen.
Come on, stop playing. Let's go. Shout him out.
Listen.
He blushing right now.
Yeah, look at him.
You don't understand how corny it was.
Nah, it ain't corny, man. Come on, that's where you started.
It was called Swag Set. Okay,
That ain't bad.
Swag Set.
Man,
it's bad in 2020. You need a name that's like going travel time. And Swag was definitely like 2000.
Who was in the crew?
It was me, my Ace Dre, and then this snitch of a 6'9" of a person named Zeus or Jabril. I don't know when around the time I became Bar Guy, this dude became Zeus too. So I don't know, but boy, this man a snitch. He was locking up the whole city when I left. Locking up the whole city.
Up.
But yeah. Bro. And we sitting here like, I can't believe y'all. Who's gonna be friends with somebody and all his friends is getting locked up?
Mm. You can't.
That's when you move to a new fucking city and start over.
Basically. I left. Like, my Ace Dre, he got locked up for 2 years messing with this dude. Like, I was gone, but see, the way I talk is the way I live my life. Properly.
So fuck that Zeus guy.
Yeah, bro. Fuck that nigga. That nigga was doing a lot, bro.
So I'm kind of glad you went through that step, though, because, you know, a lot of times when people are growing through something, at least you took the time to create something. You're the leader of your own group. You did your thing. You got some stepping stones. You got some learning mechanisms that you took with you to become the guy you are today. And I can't wait to see what's going to happen with you in a year or two.
Big facts.
Okay, you know what I'm saying?
Do you have any future plans for tours or any live performances scheduled or even on Facebook Live, anything like that?
Right now, I'm waiting for... Well, I do my Smoking Words thing, you know? Mm. Smoking Words, I host that every Thursday. Come see your boy. It's with no
name. It moved venues, didn't it?
Yeah, I was about to say.
Because I went to one of them. Mm-hmm. I went to the old venue. Because you and me were talking about that at Pegasus one night. We ended up...
Where is it?
Yeah, we at Whiskey North right now.
Whiskey North.
Yeah, there more? Like, each year is a new season, and we're like...
Is there more than one location, or is it...
No, we don't.
That was just for that other
night.
More
than one location,
whiskey.
Or just
that's
the
like whiskey as a place, but like we're probably the event people because we open mic Smoking Words, so ain't nobody trying to come out for us like that unless it's erotic night where they get half naked.
Yeah,
they was partying on the weekend.
I just
weekend.
Thought it was because of the venue, like the venue itself got in trouble.
I think it was the event or whatever because people keep asking me, but ain't nobody come to us.
No, it wasn't. It's not the venue. It's. Yeah, they had SWAT come in.
So SWAT came in shut it down? Well, then
they might
not.
They got popped. Y'all making it seem like they were trafficking. What? They got like popped.
It's the new terminology nowadays, they man. This is what happens.
Yeah.
If you come in while I'm bartending and you're not 6 feet, fucking feet apart and you're getting up to play pool and you don't have a mask on, I, as the bartender, get a ticket for that shit.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's terrible.
Yeah.
Mm. Click it or ticket.
Mm. And we can cap the...
Okay.
I don't know if they was doing too much. We good. You know what I'm saying? We good.
When y'all gonna be coming back?
Every Thursday.
Every Thursday?
Yeah, we waiting for when that curfew pop out. That's when we gonna chill, and then that's when I'm gonna go live and do all the extra stuff. I got my whole system.
You think
we're
gonna get a curfew?
First of all, martial law is coming, okay?
Yeah, that's
what you talking about. What you talking about?
I'm gonna get a curfew.
This is practice for martial law.
Just because you're in the Mad Max Theory Dome of Florida, don't mean you gonna not escape, bro. Y'all gonna catch it. What you mean?
I get canned food every time I go to the store now.
Big facts.
I feel ridiculous, but I do it though.
You got
to. We about to get another stimulus check.
All that tuna and chicken and shit.
You know why, right? Why would you need another stimulus check? Why would you need another
Because there's still 80% of the world's hospitality industry.
This is what I said.
They're killing the dollar.
What happened when we was with the last stimulus check? What exactly was going on when we had the check in our
possession? The toilet paper runs.
Quarantine was the one specific thing we had. I'm talking about Walmart had its certain times they opened and closed.
They were done by 8 o'clock.
They still do.
Think about
that. They still do. They close at 9 right now.
But I'm talking about, like, there was a time where the old people come in super early.
Yeah, they get there the first hours for the old people.
You feel me? And then you got a rush. And then they had, like, a line with some police people in the test kit.
They call that the conditioning moment.
Don't
it feel like it, though?
Yeah, I got Amazon Prime. I'm okay. All of that is irrelevant to me.
Right now, you got to feel something in the air that ain't right.
It's
you
corona. That's what's in
if
the
If I think
air.
I need something I don't know. To eat, I'm at the bar. I order my shit on Amazon. It's there when I go home. I got to go nowhere.
Anybody that's like a real...
I served somebody the other day that had the Ronies. You feel me?
Did they have diabetes, too, though?
Amazon Fresh. You can use your food stamps. Free delivery.
I don't care.
Even if you don't have Prime, you can use it.
It's the flu, bro. Am I about to dodge the rest of my life?
You can't sanitize
and interact for a natural selection. Y'all like Louis C.K.?
Yeah, I love him.
One of my favorite jokes by this guy is the peanut allergy one.
Yeah,
where he's like, "I know it's sad. I know it's sad, everybody. That you know, we got to protect everybody that gets sick off of what they eat. But you know, maybe if we just turned our eye for a year, just turn the other way, look the other way, and let these people eat peanuts, you know, maybe there's no more peanut allergy."
Yeah, exactly.
You know what I'm saying? We just let them die. Like, let it all be. That sounds hurtful.
Don't let them reproduce.
Shutter everybody who can't even catch the new common cold.
No, it's a sad situation. It's really weird right now, but you know, hopefully it'll be over soon. But I mean, I looked at a thing the other day. It said that it might be another 10 years of this shit.
No, I feel like this is going to be something I feel like social distancing was something that
it's
was created
it worse.
To make it to where they're like they're going to keep the social distance.
Naturally, it's making it worse.
They don't want us to be
around
each other.
I feel like we all need to get it and get over over with, or it's never going to fucking
I'm going to die anyway from poverty.
Listen, I remember I
made my best friend promise me.
That's the killer right there. I got to be a mom and shit. I don't want that problem.
I made my best friend promise me if I get it and I'm stuck in the fucking hospital that she comes and breaks my ass out so I can die where I want to die and not in the fucking hospital.
Yeah.
Oh, y'all planning on dying. Now, listen.
You know my best friend. You know she's resourceful.
Yeah,
I know
she's up into a little cocoon and then breaking out like a little butterfly at the end. That's
beautiful.
How I picture it. Like dying in a pod. Then I like bust a dance move. I refuse. And then like some wings pop out.
That reminds me of this a cartoon called Midnight Gospel on
I know exactly.
Yeah, I tried to watch
LSD
it.
And mushrooms. So the first time I watched it, I didn't know what I was looking at, and I realized they're doing
yeah, it's
doing
a podcast,
right now.
They're just having
an interview
and an anime,
and they're just talking to each other. It's just two people talking to each other, and that's what it was. I didn't know that.
But the cartoon is crazy.
Very psychedelic.
Like, doing too much.
Worth
I was
watching.
Like, bro,
yeah,
I gotta go.
So what I did was I get on my phone and play a game, and I just let it play in the background. I just listen to it, and I absorb all the beauty of what they're trying to convey in that.
I just go watch his podcast. Listen.
He does have a podcast, doesn't he? What's that dude's name?
I'd be forgetting his name.
I don't know his name, but I know his face. He's got one of those faces that you can't forget.
Yeah. He's got one of those faces.
Ain't that the dude from, isn't he the one from Deadpool? Listen, I swear he sounds like the dude from Deadpool.
Listen, as a black guy, my list of Caucasian entertainers is very thin. Okay, I know the Baldwin brothers. I don't even know the girl who played Catwoman. I mean, Wonder Woman. Okay, I don't know.
I don't think anybody does.
I mean,
wasn't that Halle Berry? Did you do that one time?
That was Catwoman.
Stumbled you on that one, but you get a pass because I said Catwoman. We'll
surprising you said the Baldwin brothers, though. That's not like one that comes off right away.
Oh, we listen, after Duncan I seen the Trussell. Flintstones and seen some movie called Shadow, I said, why they look similar? Why does Barney Rubble and this smooth, dapper guy playing Donald Trump nowadays, why they say, oh, they brothers? And there's two more?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
There's a younger
what
guy.
What about the Wahlbergs, man? They all look the fuck...
All I know is Marky Mark.
Yeah, shout out to Marky Mark.
I want to try one of them hamburgers they got.
They're delicious.
They don't have one out here.
I think they
we do.
Orlando.
They do?
It's
they got a Wahlburger? Oh, but that's Orlando.
Whataburger? Yeah. Isn't it
Wahlburgers.
Wahlburgers.
They like Wahlbag?
For a Wahlburger.
Wahlburger.
Marky Mark.
I want to try it.
I mean, the Nebraska Mini Mart has In-N-Out Burgers.
Nebraska? The mini mart? What they got? Like the store? Or you got to buy it and cook it yourself?
No, like they have a kitchen and all that.
What?
In-N-Out? Okay.
Yeah, in Seminole Heights.
See, what I've been driving by and what I want to like have an adventure on, like, I'm trying to get fucked up and go here, is Crystal. Because we ain't got no White Castle.
Yeah.
But adventure for some mini, I got to lean forward. See, that's why I need Oh, they couldn't hear me the whole time then.
No, they heard
you. Hear you.
Trust me, you good.
You sound better.
You good.
I'd rather.
I mean, you want to get like go on an adventure? Crystal's like literally a mile and a half from where we are.
If it's gonna be White Castle, you have to get fucked up. Make a decision
like
from
movie.
Across the town. Like you have to be nowhere near it. And then make the decision for it at inopportune times.
Why not just drive the 200 something miles to Georgia and get some White Castle?
That's an adventure.
That's
too.
The whole point. That's the adventure.
Or fucking even better than White Castle, go to fucking Pensacola and get Whataburger.
No, we need mini burgers. We're trying to catch.
Nah, they had Witty. They had Whataburger.
Some minority fun.
That didn't work.
Oh, that's you.
Whataburger died out here.
What's that say? Oh, okay. Yeah.
I heard Bojangles is popping too.
I don't like Bojangles.
You don't like Bojangles?
Spot? That's a chicken spot?
Yeah.
I only like Bojangles.
I've had it. It was all right when I was on the trip. I was hyped up, so I thought it was going to be better than
yeah.
I like some Church's chicken, man.
Yeah, I'm a Church's biscuits fan.
My ass was in the YouTube last night looking at recipes on how to make Popeyes, though. I
see,
wanted to duplicate it at the house.
Very slowly.
I messed
it
all up.
See it.
You don't y'all like Church's biscuits?
You like steroid chicken?
No, I don't eat the chicken. I go with the biscuits.
I go for okra every 9 years. Every 9 years, when the moon is full, I get me some okra from Church's because I ain't got time for their steroids.
No, I don't mess with the chicken.
The best chicken place, in my opinion, in Tampa. Is Wing Boys on 50th and Bush.
I was gonna, don't say no damn Chick-fil-A. Come on.
No, Wing Boys, they got they have 150 different flavors. They got
I like it on Sunday.
Neck bone platters.
Huh? What?
That's what I'd be hungry for. I'd be hungry.
Hey,
I'm like, plug you know
them in right now. Boom down to Wing Boys. They got the neck bone platter. What?
It's delicious.
I know it is, but I've never heard of any
Wing
spot
Boys
selling
neck bone platters.
Bro, that mean it come with sides.
Mm. Yep. That means
boiled
it's a primary
peanuts
dish.
And deep fried boiled peanuts and deep fried corn.
No, I
deep
want some collard
corn.
Greens and
deep
some
fried
macaroni.
Corn on the cob.
Deep fried corn on the cob.
I like that slide because that sounds like a novelty.
They're
of
from
wild
the
would come
they're
through.
From the islands.
It tastes like a donut with a
but like
corn
think
on
about like yo mama food like what like. Imagine a motherfucker selling hamburger helper. You know it fed the hood for years, but that shit just blow your mind. You niggas is buying $10.99.
No, you can make gourmet hamburger helper.
I know you can. You can make gourmet neck bones. Yeah. I didn't know you was gonna do that.
Yeah. You don't have
$14 for a thing of ramen, and I was like, man, this shit used to be a 59 cents.
Naruto made that jank bussin'.
It's
they
good,
put all the
but shit.
They put pork belly, eggs,
it's
all types of shit in the ramen.
It goes in it now. It's more than
I can put that in my house. I open a can of chicken, okay, and I put some garlic up in that piece. Throw some pepper. I put some a little.
A can of chicken.
Look,
you heard what he said.
I've been poor before, a long time. I've been poor.
You ain't had no chicken coming in a can.
It'll cost you $1. It'll last forever. You put
like
that
can of turkey.
Put that little bit of top
you get
ramen
spam
up in
over
there.
Ham
put some
too?
Pepper in there.
I can't do
yeah,
spam.
You gotta hook
it
up.
I can't do any meat that don't cook thoroughly through.
It's already cooked.
You feel me?
No, it's already cooked. Put that mug in there. You good?
You ever cook something that was already cooked? It can still get like drier in the middle. It can still do transform something. You know, a chemical reaction. Remember that? Yeah. Something happens to it. Raw chicken gets cooked. Spam. Only crust like the edge,
the edge
on the
edge.
Top layer.
But that's the best part.
I don't trust no creature that move like that. How you going? What?
I don't even think spam is
that's
a
just
creature.
The glue curling
bro,
up on
it's,
the side.
It's
of
creatures.
The
that's the leftover.
It's a conglomerate of creatures. I don't want that rodent.
Henry said, "Where's the magic man?"
The magic man. What is he talking about?
Is he listening?
He's watching right now.
Tell him.
Oh, he can hear us now.
He
can hear us now.
No, for real though, he doesn't get to watch us because he's not here.
Yeah, he can't watch us. Turn it off.
Turn it off.
He don't. You don't get to suggest shit. You could have suggested that shit here. Head ass. Where's the other guy? How about that? Where's the magic man? Where's the other guy?
Why don't you say hi to BarGod?
Ask him why he got two nippleless titties on his table.
Tell him to text the actual questions he would ask if he was here. Tell him to do all that.
He's doing it right here.
Do some real work.
Boom.
No, he's just antagonizing it. Where's the magic man? But he wouldn't ask that if he was here. He would ask the magic man a question. Tell him to form it like this motherfucker's
here.
Tell him
if he was here.
Ask a fucking question.
Let him text his question.
Don't say, where's
the
magic man?
Do you want us to video call you in, Henry?
Nah, he doesn't get to be
he
here.
He don't deserve
he
it.
He has to be here in person. There's rules to this game.
Tell him he's in the corner.
He says, fuck y'all.
You can't tell us the day of I'm not going
to
be here.
Tell him to roll his wheelchair over to the corner and just look at it for like 5 minutes.
Roll
before,
the wheelchair
before you start
over?
Asking us questions.
I'm not going to sit there in the corner. Because I still got some time with my
nah,
legs.
We love you, Henry. Bring your ass up here, man. We're still here. We're going to be here. Come on, man.
We'll video call you if you want us to.
Come on, Henry.
I just think about Forrest Gump.
We miss you, man. We love you.
He's got like a 30-second delay, so I'm waiting for him to...
You know how Lieutenant Dan felt, bro? I ain't got the time to be mixed with Lieutenant Dan plus asshole.
Well,
plus, I was an asshole my whole life. You know how much that would hurt?
It's a very rare.
His best friend fucks with him so hard about him not having legs. Yeah. Like, they talk shit to each other, and his best friend goes, why don't you go get hit by another fucking truck and lose your arms this time?
But see, see, that comes with real friendship.
Friendship, yes.
Second,
he's a great dude,
what
man.
I'm saying is, I make fun of a guy with no legs, then lose my legs. Now I'm sappy about it, and I'm dwelling on that.
Yeah, he's a good dude, man.
Or you'll just have somebody make fun of
you. Has the magic man ever done a strip magic show?
No, I've had opportunities, but I'm not that guy. Because
would you do it if you got offered the right amount of money to do it?
Wait, what?
No.
Henry asked if he did a strip magic show.
No, not at all. No.
Wait, you do magic?
Why does he want to see me naked now? That's the first question he had.
That's the first question he's coming out the gate.
Oh, and he says, not only does he talk shit, poet beats me. I cry every night.
Does he need help?
Do you need help? Wear a yellow shirt and take a picture.
That's probably why he ain't here. It's not my thing.
But I do know some guys that do things like that, you know.
Henry, why do you want to see him naked?
They're out in Orlando.
He saw his blue eyes.
They did a show at the Improv. They dressed with the clown makeup. You ever seen them dudes? They did a good show, man.
Which one's the blue?
I forget their names, but they do the clown makeup, and there's two of them, and they do a show together. They're really good guys, man.
It's delayed, so I don't know what he's saying right now. He's saying, bro.
It doesn't really matter at this point what he's saying.
Fuck Henry.
Bro, why can't he just text us for real? Why can't just watch something and then text us in real time?
Right.
Why we gotta come up with
because
these?
That would make
why is he
sense?
Not here on his own show?
Because he has a doctor's appointment at 8:00 for his prosthetic legs.
And it's 8:00
central. What? For prosthetic? Oh, I'm gonna tell you something. I'm gonna tell y'all some real shit. He could have right now.
And then had his doctor's appointment.
Yeah, he could have had his doctor's appointment live during the show.
Do it.
Give us some real shit.
Doctor would have got some exposure.
Let's go.
Oh God. If I've been out here, I don't know how long you've been without legs, but if you got a radio
since he was
show,
11.
That means, that makes it even all the worse. Nick, I've been out here on this earth, and I've started my own entrepreneurial business, which it falls short if I ain't, you know what I'm saying? I need to give it that panache. You feel me? I got to ask questions. And I need to wait on my prosthetic legs that I ain't had my whole life. I probably know how to do a kickflip on a skateboard with my nubs. I seen shit on YouTube and Facebook. You feel me? You can wait an extra day for your prosthetic limbs.
You can't. You couldn't show up.
They are going to hell.
Oh my God!
I was just saying.
You said a kickflip with
that's
the nubs.
I've seen a nigga missing his body wrestling nigga.
Okay. I've seen the dude. The one video where he was like took his legs off. And said, "Come on."
That nigga missing a torso.
I wouldn't have done that.
Oh, I know the guy. The half man.
If a guy is gonna try to fight me,
Shorty Dangerously,
and takes his legs off, I'm not entertaining that.
You can't do it. You can't. Nah.
That's a no win situation.
You know it's messed up if he wins.
Oh, it's a no win situation.
If he wins, if he kick you with that leg and it's in his hand, that shit.
Yeah, but the problem is if you beat him up, now you're a guy who beat up a guy when
you can't win that.
My only question is just like, why you couldn't wait an extra day?
My favorite memory with Henry being in a fucking wheelchair. We were in Ybor, drunk. Going to we're going to the Cypher
every day.
We're going to the Cypher one night, and this homeless man comes rolling up next to Henry, and he has no legs.
Oh my God! Tell me they had a race.
He goes.
He was probably sitting on him like they did.
He goes. Hey, bro.
Coming to America.
He asked Henry, "Hey, bro, are you okay? Do you need anything?" Because he thought Henry was homeless too.
What do you mean, brother?
I respect that dude because when I used to be out late in Ybor, because you can do that if you're new to the city.
Yeah,
Ybor will have you stranded, looking strung out. Don't even have
at
to do it.
5 a.m.
You will be out there strung out. I seen this nigga by an Irish pub, and he just folded into his lap with a blanket over him. He ain't got no legs. He just folded into his lap. Bro, do you know how cool that is? Just to be self-sufficient like that?
You can just pack
you
it to a little
Henry
spot.
You should see Henry get in his truck, bro. He just pulls himself up there, grabs his wheelchair, throws it in, and drives down the fucking road.
He's not a personal futon. He doesn't fold into himself and wrap himself
transform
up in Indian guards.
Like he probably could.
I don't know, man. If he can't even wait a day for the prosthetic, bro, I'm telling you.
He should have brought the doctor in with the computer.
That would have been great. Yeah, we could have did it live. Henry, you messed up. We could have did it live. You could have plugged the doctor. The doctor would have loved the free promo.
The only reason I feel like it's not that deep is only because he watched it wherever
he's still watching it.
Suggesting shit. That's what's killing me. suggesting
he wants to be
like a backseat driver.
A backseat driver on FaceTime
with a suicide shift because he can't push the pedal.
He ain't even in the car.
He's like, no, go right.
Suicide shift because he can't touch the fucking pedal.
Hey, I seen them shit. Them shits used to work. Oprah used to get them niggas paid for back in the day. I remember that.
I never seen it.
You never seen a motherfucker that's like missing a limb and like, well, usually it's their feet, and then they get extra paddles. Around.
See, no, I never seen that.
My ex lost his leg, and he rode a motorcycle.
You have an experienced like it's a
that is
traverse life.
I do.
That is very like.
Oh, his doctor is Samir Puri, whatever.
The word's good. No, see, you should have shouted him out.
That's my
bring his ass up here.
That's the guy that owns the Metro store right up the road.
So, what, he got his prosthetic. He had his prosthetic for like 6 months.
Works at the 7-Eleven during the daytime.
They said, you're not supposed to be on a motorcycle.
Oh, my God. He probably ran this building to us.
That's fucked up.
And he put a suicide shift at the top. This motherfucker was not ready to be on a motorcycle. We stopped at a fucking stop sign. You're supposed to be able to put your feet down to hold the fucking bike up. I had to jump up and hold the fucking bike up because
that's
the bike
though.
We were
breaking
like
the law.
That's love though.
He was breaking the fucking leg. He had no leg.
That's love though. Oh,
why would he be? God. Never mind.
Why would he? Because that's love though. Remember that.
That's love though.
He says,
that's
love. He says we're all racist as fuck and his truck is automatic.
First of all, he don't want to know where my racism goes. Okay. He don't want to know.
We hope so. Shit. We hope it's automatic. It better be.
Better
that
be
nigga
great.
Be out here shifting hard.
Yo.
Oh my God.
I don't drive stick at all, so it took me a minute to get that one. And it hit all the more sweeter when it finally sunk in. Do you hear me? That there is a whole nother pedal. Think about right. that. You don't even use
ask
it.
Him, ask him if he knows.
He can hear you.
We're going to have to wait 8 minutes.
Do you know, is there any that he suggests that he's done background on that we could get the listeners to maybe do some donations towards, like, maybe kids that need prosthetics? Does he know of
we
any
never
of
tried
those?
That.
That's we've never
idea.
Tried doing
why
an
not?
Event like
why
that,
not?
But we could definitely do something
maybe
like
ask
that.
Him if he knows the name of a .com or somebody where, you know, we can find out. We
I like
know,
this guy. He's got a good head on his shoulder.
We should know about this type of thing.
And he says his doctor also works at a customer service call center, man. Fuck time.
We already could have guessed
wait,
that.
Why what? You pick a nigga that's so fucking introvert? Bro, why you pick a nigga that's got alternate shifts and gigs, bro? Oh, God,
we
could have
guessed. I don't trust that doctor.
I got my doctor, my pediatrician. It's okay. He's also a veterinarian. Like,
man,
bro,
we're all good.
He's hey,
it's fine. He gets a power nap.
I'm just glad he doesn't work at a furniture store. He's going to send him home with some furniture.
But he's
some
Indian,
table legs
of course
and
he
shit.
Works in
the
a
foundation
center.
For the kids is called the PAR Foundation. P-A-R-R
Foundation.
P-A-R-R
Foundation. PAR Foundation.
Yep.
Wait, spell it again.
P-A-R-R Foundation.
What are we talking about?
And that's where the kids can get their prosthetic. Let's donate some money to the PAR
Let's
Foundation,
do it.
Y'all. Come on.
Next
Let's
time, once we have that in advance, I'll put the graphic up.
I got $5.
Let's go.
I can start with.
I like this guy.
I can start with. I got more later. I got more later.
Own
but
foundation
today is all I got.
Also,
I ain't even tripping. Look,
Cash App, real bar guy. Real bar guy. Cash App, real bar guy.
R-E-A-L.
We were talking about giving you subjects so you could freestyle.
We're starting it right now. Put the money between the titties. Look.
That's titty money.
PAR Foundation. That's what he said.
I ain't shit. I almost looked at my girl. Was like, five, bro. Let's get it. He's talking about these titties. He's talking about
let's get it. Let's
fake titties.
And shoot. If somebody can start donating $5 at a time to that foundation, we could help a lot of kids with their prosthetics, and maybe we'd have our co-host here if he was part of that foundation.
Yeah, if
he
had
was
his
younger,
prosthetic sense alone,
he would have been
be
here.
Different.
But you know, I'll match.
I'm
anybody.
With that.
I'll match anybody. Up
to
$50
I guess he tried
if
to book an
get.
Event to
that's
raise
I,
money for that foundation before.
Oh, he's already on it, or
he no, he, listen to this. He says he tried to book them an event to raise money for the foundation, but every band that he had. You know, going to donate their time to the show was too heavy. I had an instrumental fusion.
Yeah, that makes sense.
And they bitched about it. I gave up after that.
What do you mean it was?
Oh, so the people who own the actual
foundation, they didn't want donations.
They didn't
from,
want
like,
the heavy,
heavy
metal
show.
Yeah,
well, shit, give my $5 back. I was trying to match.
No, you a magician. You a black magician during a time of racism. We need all the minority.
Wait, so no, wait, yo, so he's really you're really a magician?
Yeah.
Oh, see now, I didn't know this. I'm just meeting him for the first time, bro.
He's really a magician.
Focus it on you, so that's what I did.
Yeah, I didn't see
I
that.
I know, but you can still tell him that he really a magician.
She don't tell me nothing. There's no communication here.
I had a dream.
It's like a bad relationship.
Card.
We don't talk.
You got
we just
kind of
just back to back end of the night. I don't know. I'm all out. I ran out.
See, I could have just told him to come over there and blow your mind real quick with a little quick trick. But see, you failing because you ain't got no business cards.
You know what's funny is
last night. No, I got business cards. They're just not mine.
Last night I had a dream that I was doing a magic show. And because of COVID, I haven't done a magic show in so long that I failed in my dream. I still made the show happen, but that joke was real to me. I was like, man.
Can you do something now? Are you
going to? He doesn't like being put on the spot.
You don't want to be put on the spot? Okay, no, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it.
We'll do it over time.
Yeah.
Do it over time.
He likes no, because I'm
fucking, listen, I'm a motherfucking kid at heart, so yeah. I fucking love magic, bro. Shout out to, do you know Corey Van Valen?
That's my boy.
That's
man.
The homie.
Like, you know what's funny about me and Corey is we got to do a show together. Let's get him on. Let's do a show together. Because people are funny. Like, when he's out doing a show, they always think that they'd be like, "Have you heard of Antwan Towner?" And I'm like, and then when I'm performing, they'll say, "You ever heard of Corey Van Valen?" And they don't realize like we're friends.
Yeah,
and but we because
you got to think is that a smaller, tighter knit business community.
Yeah, it's not that many of us.
So y'all, do you guys beef a lot or no?
Never. No,
I got about
that's what I'm saying because I see you guys always support each other.
We do, but it's funny because everybody thinks we beef. Everybody thinks that we're like they really assume like that's how like we're not rappers, you know. I mean,
yeah,
we
exactly.
Don't, I don't make money like that, you know.
That's cool. That's cool.
Yeah, I'm actually in the business. So we're actually friends. We work on stuff. We work on ideas. We're going to do something together.
He was actually going to do the beats and eats that I had right before the Rona came.
Really?
He was supposed to do the beats and eats. He was going to come there and do magic while I had the artist performing and stuff.
Oh, he's great, man.
Yeah. That's the homie. Shout out to Corey.
Corey Van Valen.
But it ain't no Swarovski or whatever. All right, so we were talking that night, but I guess he was drunk and doesn't remember this conversation.
I do that sometimes. I get drunk.
Last Monday when we met up, we were talking about giving you subjects.
I'm trying not to right now, but I'm
just
still
giving
doing
you
it.
Subjects and letting him freestyle and.
Y'all got beats though. Is that
of
the question?
Of course, I got beats.
Okay,
I got beats
then.
Right now.
Yeah.
And then that's then there we go. That's
you
want to
pick? You want to pick?
Let me see what I got. Let me give you something.
Perfect.
So where are we going? Right White Lie later.
White Lie, man. I'm still hurt. That thing is a whole new spot.
Yeah, because it was Red Star the last time.
You good with this one?
I mean, yeah, it's a throwback.
I'm 90s, man.
Yeah, he's but old. I'm gonna tell you something. You're gonna get bars, but if you want more entertainment and more fast beat, you know
what you
saying?
Want?
A faster beat.
Some faster.
I can do this, but I mean, okay, I'm gonna show you what I do to a slow beat while you look for a fast beat.
Let's go.
Okay, turn that shit up a little bit. Okay, cool in the back. Acting just like it's magic. She say that it's cool. Well, I'm sharper. I'm through a hatchet. Maverick. Oh, we be sitting here with the titties. Girls wildin' now. Caucasian. Oh, for the villain. Never for a village. They say a nigga be silly. Shop at PacSun, but never been to Umtile. Oh, okay. You get it. Fish fillet like it be chicken. Ain't no Sunday. But right now, she looking for the FM radio. Let's pretend that we there. I won't curse and leave in a snare. They tell me move in a hair. Not tortoise. That be a shell. Leaving out like our ridges. They see our nigga be moving. I'm turning out front pages. Cause never judge a book by its cover. Lest you shudder. Lest you stutter. Lest they tell me what you got until you utter. They say it's milk over that nigga. That bees with a udder. She tell me that I be street fluid. That'll be a gutter. Please tell your mother a Kama Sutra but better. Open up umbrella like A-A-A-A. Rihanna for play. She put it up on my plate. Pussy wet for a day. I say that shit on my grace. Okay. Dyslexic, reading words like it's backwards. Say that she an actress, baby girl, I'm an actor. Just to come over, she said that it's a prefix. She came before me, and I ain't even see it. Skating on the Healy, my double helix is spinning. Okay, cool with the church, but right now I'm still sinning. The Grinch who stole Christmas, all green while I'm grinning. And I don't really care for civil rights unless it's sipping.
What are you talking about? See, that's the thing. That's the thing. You just kind of slow down.
Yeah, you feel me, but I'll be like,
I understand, because you get comfortable in a certain tempo. I feel you, trust me.
And this is my guy right here. We can argue 3 hours about Drake.
I love Drake.
We can argue three hours about this sensitive nigga. Real quick, but y'all ain't even throwing words. He got the camera out. I guess I got my own mind to go splurge. What am I looking at for words? Oh, Antwan the magician. You should see this nigga do a trick. It's more than terrific. She say it's more than specific. Or nah, that's the pussy wet. It's drowning Pacific. Okay, cool with this crown. And they say that I'm royal. It's not cool for the saran wrap unless I came foil. Ooh, proof dominatrix. So we pulling out the cellular. I gotta bite an apple. I ain't got the time for her. Words out synopsis before they can get a crop pick. She don't really like. But my headphones got me shopping. beat the beats up, you get it beats, they making headphones. If the shit works well enough, it leave your head gone. Boom, not another, but that'll be a cyclone. Bitch say I'm writing in pencil, need me a hydro. Hilly, not for really, she say that I'm getting silly. I'm acting like a nigga just moving without the grilly. Tell me that you nice when I'm moving before prevailing. Is that a cock ring? Well, baby girl, I'm excelling. Dick so long and stay hard, I'm intrusive, exclusive. Introduce anything that I was new to. Is this a bracelet? Silver kill the bear, well, where the wolf at? I tell him that it's twilight. I mean, where? Okay, cool, never scare. Michelin, that took a tear. That'll anybody who don't know that I'd be there. Yeah, we still got it. We ain't even bring the crack out. Girl, look sexy. You got a thong. I see the crack out.
Oh. I told you it was dope. Day one, man. I'm telling you.
We be chilling. I be wanting a dry erase board so we can just write words on that.
Oh, my God. And just, like, hold it up. Like, what's that?
There. Yeah. That would be.
What's that one stupid game where you, like, write, like, clues?
Heads up.
Oh, the, what is it, charades? Oh, no, wait, the
now where you, like, act it out, where you draw it.
Oh, that was,
oh, Pictionary.
Yeah, Pictionary.
Oh, see, now we might have to do that after this. We might have to all go to my crib, get fucked up, and fucking draw some shit.
Do you have Pictionary over there?
No, Pictionary is such a, oh.
Yo, what's that, you said, what's that?
Speaking of words.
Bob Barker?
I bring a book, but this is so I can't see what you're doing. Since you're way over there, I'm going to do something.
Word. Quick.
This
let's go.
Is just random.
Let's go.
Sometimes people pick a word out of a book.
Bet.
Just random.
I'm with it. Let's
and
go.
And I'm sure he could rap about it right after.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, so you could think of a word now if you could flip through the book if you want to. You just pick a word if you like. Doesn't matter. What I want you to do is write it down real big right there.
Got you.
And then take the paper once you're done.
Got
so
you.
I can't see it.
Got
me,
you.
Let me know when you finish. I'm going to hand this over to you. My Bob Barker.
Exclusive. Book. Exclusive.
Let's go.
My Bob Barker book. I love Bob Barker.
Antwan Towner, the magician. God damn it. Can y'all see that shit?
That dude is hilarious.
The camera's up here, baby.
Let's go. Let's see if you find this one out.
All right. Just think of something and then write it down.
And keep the paper?
Yeah, yeah. So we can't see what you've done. Gotcha. There's no cameras over there, is it?
No.
Okay.
I can't even.
Okay. This is going to be interesting.
All right, so here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to flip through the book.
All right.
I'm going to flip through the book at random, okay? So I'm going to try to get to a full page, all right? So I'm going to get to a full page, something like this. I'm going to run my finger through the page and hopefully be able to find your word. All right, so Allie, what I want you to do is just tell me where to stop randomly.
Okay. Stop.
Right there. Okay, so we got a full page. Once again, tell me where to stop.
Stop.
So that word right there is the word games. Is that close to your word at all?
Not at all.
There's no G in it anymore.
Nothing.
Not
nothing.
At all?
Nothing.
Dang, that didn't work. All right, so here's what I'm going to do.
That's what I'm saying. I made sure I picked the word.
Don't worry about it. I got a piece of paper right here. So let me write something down.
That was part of the trick, people.
Here's what I got. I'm going to write something down. Okay? Right, and we can flow this into what you're going to do.
Yeah, yeah, I'm here.
I
know this one.
All right, now we didn't set anything up before.
No, absolutely not. That's where I hope you get this.
So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to have you think of your word for me. Just think of anything.
I'm doing it right now.
You got something in your head?
Got you.
All right, you think of your word. Think of the letters.
Looking right at it. Looking right at it right now.
All
right,
are you saying it in your head so you don't...
I am saying it. I want you to get this right. Because this is the kid in me.
You're saying the word in your head right now.
Does this
have anything to do with an artist of any type? Anything to do with an artist?
I don't think so. I mean, it's just a word that I saw.
See, I'm getting you know Sade? You guys know who she is?
Yeah, I know who Sade is. That's my girl. Ah, love me some Sade.
You love Sade. Do you know what her last name is?
No.
I do.
I fucking hate you. Are you serious? Keep going. I fucking hate you. I fucking hate you. Keep going, though. No.
I've seen this. I love it.
BarGod, this is the word that I've got
written
down.
I swear if that's the word, I'm going to cry.
It is.
I am going to fucking cry.
You were saying it in your head.
Yes.
This is the word.
Oh, shit! Yo! D-D-D-D!
Adulation is his word.
How did you do that?
Was that your word?
That adulation
in the book, man. I'm telling you.
Right fucking there.
It's in the book now. Look at that.
Bro, I told you it was still part of the tree. In a world of pure adulation.
Hold up. How'd you do that?
Very well, thank
you. How did you do that?
Very well, thank
you.
This is mine. Yeah.
What does adulation even mean?
Exactly.
Does anybody even know what that means?
Who did that? How did you do that?
I believe it.
I'm about to Google this shit.
Yo, how did he do that?
Yeah, there we go.
Yo, how did you do that?
Hey.
How did you do that?
Quick out there, if you know what the meaning of it is, type it in real quick before I guess it.
Good how answer. The hell did he do that?
Antwan Towner, the thought seer.
Flattery, excessive.
Admiration.
Yeah. Oh, adulation.
It's how you care for somebody, how you love them, how you
How did you do
them.
That?
And I know you love Sade.
Adulation.
Adulation is what we get as artists.
Yo, how did he do that?
I'm hearing a little feedback. What is that?
That's wait, me you know screaming. That? That's him yelling, saying that he's
my bad, my bad.
Antwan Towner.
That was dope.
The motherfucking magician.
Thank you.
You know what I like about it? It's a black magician. Oh.
How did he do that?
I don't see too
when
many.
When I was a kid, I wasn't that good at it.
I don't see too many African American magicians.
Which trick did you mess up in your dream?
I don't. It wasn't that one. It wasn't that one. I'll tell you that.
It was something like it. It was actually a trick I had never done before. It was a dream where I had everyone. It was very similar though. I had everybody write down a word in the audience, but I realized like in the dream you can't do that anymore because I can't go approach an audience anymore. It's against the law, you know. So I had everybody in the audience write down a word. They threw it in a hat, and I brought somebody on the stage. They reached in the hat, and then I told them what it was. So that was actually the dream.
How did you do that? I'm so bummed.
Man, look,
there was 100 words on the back of the book.
I can tell you. Look, I can tell you this.
Was that one in bold or something?
It's called fucking magic.
That's crazy.
He's like, nigga, is that italicized?
No, but look at me though.
Was it underlined, motherfucker?
I am an intern. Ever since I turned like 20, bro, straight up like, I need to know what's wrong. There's something wrong.
If you remember,
I'm gonna figure it out. That's crazy.
If you remember, I asked you to think of a word before you looked in the book. But some people use the book to look. They just look in any book.
But still, I could have picked out
Yeah, thank you, man.
I could have picked out these nuts.
You know what I'm saying?
Is that for him? I'm drinking his drink. Look. Yeah, get him one.
That is crazy, bro.
That's early drink out. Let me just put that.
Oh, my bad. I got his volume all the way up.
I didn't want him to have to drink the liquid.
Yo, how did he do that? How did he do that?
Hey, you knew I knew that was coming, right? I just sat here and I was like...
How magic is funny is this? I wasn't good at it when I first...
I'm glad you're mad you're not here,
Antwan
motherfucker.
Antwan the magician or Twan the sorcerer?
You said that when I get drunk...
I like Twan the sorcerer.
You do, but my favorite, like... When you fuck with people and you read people's minds, that's like my favorite.
How did he do that?
Because you do it when you're drunk, and people ask him all the time. They'll walk up to him and be like, hey, can you do a magic trick? And he goes... I don't do shit on command. I said, you just gotta like let him do it.
Yo, that's crazy.
Here's what's crazy. So when I was a kid, I used to practice with silly things. I used to have stuff laying around the house. So here, I want to just show the camera real quick. They can just see. I've got some envelopes here. I'm just putting it in the frame.
Oh, okay.
Just so they can see.
I got three envelopes.
I got some envelopes here. Okay. Back. So yellow, red, and blue. Allie, ladies first. It's up to you.
Ladies first.
Which one would you like? This is how my tricks look when I was like 7. All right.
Yellow.
This is how I look when I was. You want to use yellow? Not because it's on top.
Yellow.
You absolutely sure?
Yeah.
You positive?
Mm-hmm.
You don't want to change your mind?
Nope.
All right. Would you reach in there and just grab out what's inside?
Oh God.
Dig for your soul.
Don't look at it yet. Don't look at it yet. Just pull that out and just hold it close to you.
Okay.
Don't look at it yet. We'll look at it in a minute. All right. So BarGod. It's up to you.
How do we set that up?
It's up to you. There's a blue and there's a red.
My favorite color. In my childhood was red, but right now it's gonna be blue.
Blue
is my favorite color now.
I want you to reach in there and just grab out what's inside there.
I'm
and just hold
just
that,
like her.
Hold that close to
I'm gonna do that just like she did.
I need that for my.
I didn't know if I was like black and stuff.
Look, I'm doing it like you.
Was that as fair as it could be? You could have went with any one of them. You grab yellow.
Yeah, you could have went with the red ring.
Could have went any way at all. Yeah. Now inside of mine, I'm gonna grab out what's inside here. And just so you guys don't think I'm tripping or nothing, could you hold on to that for me just for a second? Thank you
so much.
How
did he do
that? All right.
That's my security. Brandon's security in the corner, everybody.
All right, so Allie, I don't know if they can see it on the camera when you open it up.
But, her camera's right here.
This was my trick when I was 7. So don't. It's not that impressive. But just if you could open up what's inside.
My God.
Yeah, read it out loud. What does it say? And just show the camera.
That's funny.
What does it say?
That's funny.
It says you will select yellow, and you did. This is amazing, right? For a 7-year-old
that's
trick.
That's pretty good. That's pretty good. That's pretty good.
BarGod, you picked blue. You could have picked any one of them.
I could have picked the red ring.
You will choose blue, and you did. You see, when I was 7, I thought that was the most clever thing in the world. But the thing is, you guys left me with this one.
That's right.
And it could have went any other way, or could it have?
It could have. It could have went any way.
Hold on, look.
I swear to God.
It says, the man will choose blue, the woman will choose yellow, and I will be left with red.
Bitch, we just got AGT. Bitch.
How did he do that, though?
America's Got Talent. Bitch, we just got
y'all
AGT.
Y'all setting me up. I feel like you set me up. I feel like you planned this.
Thank you. No, but you can't plan it.
Hey, you want me to tell you what fucks that all up? You want me to tell you what fucks that all up?
Go ahead.
This nigga showed up 3 minutes before we walked in the fucking building. We didn't even have time with this motherfucker. He was the last nigga to show up.
He thinks I'm setting him up, but when I do actually set him up, he's got a little crush.
Oh my God, this is how many times are you going to bring this up? Every episode? Are you doing this every episode?
Every episode.
Are you doing this every episode?
I'm going to sneak her in here.
Oh my God.
Oh, you want to guess which one it is?
Oh my God, don't do this.
It's a Gaspar's bartender.
Oh man. Oh, it's one of my favorite places in the world. Let
me
tell you something about
every episode.
Short, petite, skinny.
Gaspar's is the only business in Ybor City that ever pays me and paid me money to perform.
Yeah,
that's the only business that supports me, and I support them. They really do support me. Now, I know they do some other stuff out there.
Yeah, some fuck shit.
But they are the only company in the entire city that ever hired me and paid me money to do what I do.
She's got purple hair now, Henry.
Oh my God!
And they told me, that I can come back anytime I want to. I'm for real. That's what they said.
Her name's Erin.
Oh my God,
bro! She didn't even guess yet.
Wait a minute, huh?
She ain't shit. We didn't even guess.
She didn't need to guess. She likes doing this.
Hey, yo, she go harder than Angela Yee, nigga. She is like the Charlamagne of this motherfucker.
For those paying attention at home, never ever tell her anything.
I don't tell all your secrets. It's just funny because you. Blush when I say Aaron's name.
You want me to give you something? You want me to give you some advice?
Go ahead.
She, as your friend, thinks this is funny, right?
Yeah, it's good.
But I bet you $5 it's even funnier because you might be slightly embarrassed, but she knows the fact that she mentions it. If she's mentioning it out loud, there's a chance that you have a chance, but she knows that you ain't going to shoot the shot.
No, I'll never shoot the shot.
But she knows that you have a chance, or why else mention it?
I don't think she would.
I'm not going to put you out there and you don't even have a chance.
I don't think I would. I don't think I do, but if I do, that would be awesome. Mm-hmm. I hope this leads to that.
Yeah, you won't know until you try.
Know until I try.
Me and Henry went up there on a Saturday to see if she was working, so we could bring her today.
But anyways, I still need to know how the hell you knew what word I picked. Out of all the words.
He's not going
to
tell you
That is incredible.
Shit, I thought that was old.
Yo, his mind
that's never going to go away. Like I said, I'm a kid, bro. That is never going to go away.
Adulation and befuddled.
Adulation. Can I keep the two things?
Oh, that's for you, man.
I'm
going to
hang
you.
Those up.
That's for you.
Because
it really happened. It really happened in real life. In real life, for real. Hello.
Out of all the words.
So you get a motherfucker here. Is that ejaculation?
Sergio, you should actually see one of his performances.
No, I'm down now.
You would.
You know what's crazy is look at our handwriting. It's actually almost the same.
It really is, though, almost the same. Oh, my goodness.
Y'all both was like writing on.
That is crazy. I can't wait to watch this again. I cannot believe out of all the words.
Every magician's got to start with card tricks. That's how I started out. When I'd be drunk at the bar, sometimes you catch me with a pack of card tricks, and I might do.
Although
something.
The other night when I was talking to you, you didn't seem drunk to me. That's why when you came up to me,
I don't even remember doing it.
The magic of evil.
You came up to me a white light, like I saw you the other night, right? And I'm like, yeah.
I don't remember any of that.
We talked for good 20-30 minutes. You were there.
And you were there.
And you were there.
And you were there.
And you were there. And Toto. You were there. And Auntie M.
So when did you start doing magic?
I started doing magic when I was 7 years old.
Okay.
Yeah, it was something in my heart. I was just able to kind of connect with people. Man, I was in a foster home when I was a kid, so that was my way out. It was like my way of, you know, just making people laugh and smile and feeling rich on the inside. I think a lot of us need to kind of feel successful and rich on the inside before
Absolutely.
We can attain it in actual reality. So that was my way of connecting to the universe in that way.
What made
you guys want a really good laugh real quick?
Yeah.
What do we got?
Henry's doctor didn't show up.
Oh, fuck him. Because he's at 7-Eleven.
Hold up. I thought we came to that conclusion already.
No, the doctor appointment got moved, but his doctor didn't show up for the actual appointment.
Wow.
That guy's a
First
dick.
Of all, this man making bread, and he probably done sold somebody on a T-Mobile hotline. iPhone 11 and 2 smartwatches.
And that's during the daytime.
Your prosthetic for $18.
He got that commission. Is $350.
He got
right
that
now.
Commission. Right, he's straight. He don't need to come to work.
Tell him he owe him.
Why
somebody.
Go to the hospital? Sell another
Tell
iPhone.
Doctor,
this man ain't had prosthetics in over. What's 7 minus how old he is? No, what's 11 minus how old he
that's
is?
A brand new deck. Yeah.
You think I'm a rush? The nubs got callus on him. He chilling, bro.
He's straight, bro. Should have been came in.
He's not traumatizing. Oh, he gets fried every day. If he gets fried, then I know you can make a... Wait a second.
He would have loved to see a magic trick.
Oh, that was classic.
I would have loved for him to pull like an envelope.
Tell his doctor
out that nigga wheelchair. I can't even say this all. I didn't put this down before you sat down, did I? Nope.
You opening the cards up?
Yeah.
So I didn't even remember I was
doing it. Okay, bet.
But that's like, you know, every time I hang out with BarGod, I see him like just do his art, man. He'll end up just having a group around him, loving every word that comes out of his mouth. And to me, that's magic. Like, it's literally magic to me. I get impressed by other people's art and what people's passion is, and I see that and I'm like, yo, that guy right there, like, that guy, he's got it, man. And I think that's been our connection, you know what I'm saying? Like, man.
I'm trying to get him paid. I need him to take me on Disney with him. So as he does the act, I just Dr. Seuss.
We'll figure something
out. In rhyme the whole time. Oh, little Timmy picked card number 3. Will he shimmy or will he even remember me? Let's find. You feel me? Like, let's just do some real basic stuff.
That would be, yeah.
From Disney really poetic. When you get to return or no?
Well, before the COVID thing happened, they already booked me for November, December, January, and February for my act. And they had booked that way before February. So I knew I was already on the books, but I have not worked since February. So when we can gather groups again, you know, I'll be back in business.
Wasn't Disney open?
Yeah, but I work on the cruise line. So I'm mainly, I'm mainly on the ship.
Also, because they're separate entities.
Different company. it's one company, but it's a different company. Yeah, they'd be different, also. Different, completely different companies. Yeah,
he does both, by the way. That's why I separated.
Yeah, man. Yeah, yeah. And that's a weird position to be in, too, because, like, my lifestyle in real life is I live in Ybor City. And, you know, I see you guys all the time, but my work life is very, you know, it's for families, you know what I mean? It's a family environment. I can't just go to, like, an improv and just say, you know,
pick a card, motherfucker.
Dick, I mean, why not,
dick
though?
Pussy ass and shit, and
why
goodbye.
Not,
good night.
You can have the adult show.
Yeah, you know, I'm working on it, man. I just don't want to get Louis C.K. back to him. I don't want to get true. I don't want to get Louis C.K.'d. I don't want to get, like, even they fuck with Kevin Hart even for being
well, yeah, it's we're in a weird time.
You can't
right
say
now.
Nothing no
yeah,
more.
But listen,
you know
listen
what I'm saying, like, it's hard.
Listen, I'm gonna tell y'all
make
some
everybody
sign
a waiver. Yeah.
It doesn't even matter about that. Choose your shit now. Cause as me, I could go into detail. You feel me? My life is crazy, but
I've
the reason
writing.
I get away with it is because I chose the little, I'm a comedian, I'm a host.
Absolutely.
And then, like, I blabber, so he talks a lot, I can say what I want, and so now you can't even get mad at me, just like that Dave Chappelle joke.
Right.
I told you I fucked a fat bitch. You
right,
feel me?
Right.
I told you I fucked that fat bitch. Mm. And you gave me a high five. Now, when you see videotape footage, don't get upset. Don't lose shame in me. Don't lose respect for me because all of a sudden you've seen something. Mm. So now that's what I would say. Whatever, if you think you could do something.
Yeah, I've been writing. I want to create. I want to sit down and some more. You know, I look at show business a little bit differently. Like, man, I really think all the meetings are important. Like, when we first hung out, we actually had a real meeting during the daytime. And a lot of cats, like, they won't meet with me during the daytime. We just drink together. Mm. And, like, I'm like, if we can drink together, we can have a meeting together.
Yeah, absolutely.
Meet me at noon. You know what I'm saying? Like, meet me at noon. Meet me at 9 a.m. Meet me at 1 p.m. Like, just talk before 5 p.m. And then let's still do what we do after that. But let's meet, and because I take it seriously. Mm-hmm. So we do that. You know, we do that. You know, it's not a problem. Even me and your man did that. You know, he was at he came to White Line with us.
Yeah, he was there.
Your
that
guy,
night.
Not your man, but your guy. Is it Henry?
Henry.
Me and Henry was there. Couple times Henry was there, first time. And back to the whole, you know, joking about the whole thing is, like, Henry's such a cool dude. I didn't even notice, like, he didn't have no legs the first time I met him. We were just talking.
That's why we named the show Breast and Thighs, because he doesn't have
legs. I realized that today on my way here. I was like, why is the show?
He's only got thighs.
I was like, why is the show called that? I had no idea. Breast and Thighs, everybody. Breast and Thighs. Breast and Thighs.
Someone's got the thighs. Someone's got the thighs.
I didn't even realize. That dude's a man. He's a good dude, man.
Henry climbed up on the table and wiggled his nubs in the air.
Hell yeah.
They were shaking their nubs.
As well he should have.
Yeah, they were. It was cool.
Did you guys put some tassels on them like they was in the titties? Like,
we need to.
Is that where these nipples went? Is that where these nipples went? Or did you guys put them on his knees as a joke?
I cannot.
Henry's legs could fit in these. They got these little metal things. But
look,
look,
Henry, you don't even need that doctor. We got you.
I
right
cannot
here.
And I will not.
It ain't that long, but we got you. Now I'm playing.
I cannot and I will not.
It would fit, though.
I cannot.
Par foundation. We're gonna
look it up. I wouldn't take y'all money either. Listen, you're not about to host a metal concert.
with some hardcore motherfuckers that don't care if they ever lose a life or limb or whatever.
Shoot, I'm a host.
Then fry me on your radio station.
I don't care where the money comes from, just as long
as
you
keep your dirty money where you've been selling the crack and talking to all these hostile people. All that money, we only accept the money from the Jesus of the Christ.
Oh, speaking of the Jesus people, so I hosted a...
Is this what you want to do? You sure you want to do this?
Oh, my Lord.
They got a big following.
Oh, Lord. And we had a busy night. It was wonderful, you know?
All the Jesus
A whole people. Fucking bunch of people. I go outside to go check the parking lot and, you know, do my job. I shit you not, man. The Jesus people came out 20 cars deep and tried busting into the concert.
Don't tell them where it is. They're going to
show
up
concert?
Again.
What concert?
Yo, that's crazy.
What concert?
And people,
they wanted to hear some
this
music.
This is like some death metal shit, man.
They were sick of all that bullshit.
Like
they be let playing in the gospel
people
choir. Would
say, no, thank you. And they would still try to shove it in their face, so people started lighting them on fire and throwing them.
Wait, what?
That's a lot to deal with. That's I don't want that.
I mean, but think about it. If I think you a heathen and I really believe in hell and you going to hell, it must be that you don't want to fuck with me because I'm cool. You must want that fiery shit. Let me light my shit on fire. That's because you want that shit.
Oh, Jesus.
You want some fire.
No, we did that to them.
Oh.
Y'all lit them on fire?
Hey,
did y'all see that video of the girl pouring the gasoline in a dude's car and she blew herself up? Oh my Lord. She was dumb as hell.
Why would you stick your head in there?
She burned all her eyebrows off.
Hold up. I left for a second.
And her lashes came off, melted to her eyeball.
This girl burnt her ex's car up, right?
She dumped gasoline
in it.
That was terrible.
I seen that.
She's in hell.
What you just talking about remind me of this.
She's alive.
It says, I probably ran across my soulmate, but I think he was a Jehovah's Witness, and I never answered the door. You know what I'm saying? Like,
it happens.
Could you imagine that?
You know what's wild is, like, I never heard a story. Like, we even heard that about Lisa Left Eye Lopez. She didn't caught the man's house on fire and everything through the
Andre Rison.
But, look, when do you hear a dude just... just burning up a girl's car, like you don't.
I haven't heard that, but no,
I heard that.
I heard recently a dude shot somebody in the foot twice.
That's a lot
for getting beat up.
I don't want to deal with that.
You said I gotta pee.
If I had to pee, I'd
tell him to call Henry's doctor.
Get
some new feet.
First of all, we're not calling Henry's doctor because that man has 15 jobs.
Yeah, and he's not showing up to the
Henry's
office.
Henry's doctor?
We just going to get some beef jerky at 7-Eleven. He's going to be there.
I have Henry's doctor.
We do got his name. We can look him up.
But what was the doctor's name?
She's got it right there.
Because I bet you it's some generic shit that we going to get about another 10.
Well, I know the doctor's office is in Chicago. So
I think he's lying to us. I think he just didn't want to come to the show.
P-R-I-M-B.
It's okay. I'm a boom in a couple. I'm already booming now, and it's a problem. Because I didn't want to boom.
He going to sue us for defamation.
Y'all should have asked the right questions. How you get on HBO and you in Tampa, nigga? What the fuck you doing? Nigga, we don't trust that shit. Listen, we going to boom soon, though. Because you ain't seen magic and bars come together.
That's
you haven't.
True. That's true.
And
that's
you know what I hadn't seen, which would have been real dope? I ain't seen Magic Bards or a nigga that's missing legs come together.
Not at all. Not
do you
at all. That's the trifecta. That's the trifecta right there.
He's strong as fuck, too. Like,
Daniel's son.
Yeah. He likes to fight.
First of all,
he's cool
as
too,
a
man.
Short nigga,
I like him.
I have to fight big niggas and I come out on top, which is why there's no beauty.
Well,
blemishes.
Henry is only like this tall.
My point. And so I could only imagine what he got going.
Where is he? He could have been.
It's
got
to be worse.
He could have been here
he
by
now.
He
could fuck a nigga. He probably
don't
even kick a nigga in the shins.
He
just
showed up.
Run over tubs. And
that would be funny if he just showed up right now. And
now, he got arm strength, though.
I heard
he got arm strength.
If he gets on top of you,
two
sledgehammers, you
done. Stop tripping.
Henry, how much can you bench now?
I think he said he was.
Is he still watching?
Yeah.
He don't got nothing else to do. What's he got to do?
On you.
In the words of my mother and Wendy Williams, you're fired.
He was supposed to be picking out legs right now, but it's
Wendy
not
Williams
happening.
I'm too sexy for my...
Isn't she a dude?
She looked like something.
I thought she was a dude.
Who? I don't know what that is.
Wendy Williams?
Oh, first of all, Wendy Williams, I want everybody to know this real quick. Yeah, drum roll for my opinion.
Wait,
because it is fact.
I got a drum roll.
You got a drum roll?
I got a drum roll.
I'm about to tell y'all some real shit. Because
okay,
I know genetics. Trust me. Okay? I moved to Florida and went to one of y'all pride parades and still pulled all the bitches that were genetically, gender, basically born. I'm telling you.
You ready?
All women. Yeah, give
Let's
me that.
Let's go.
Give me that drum roll.
Okay.
Ah, y'all ready for it? Y'all want to know what Wendy Williams is? Because I'm telling you, I got the eye. I know. She is. That is a nigga, bro. What you talking about? Oh, God. What you mean? What you mean? I didn't see you have birth with them kids. You know what's real crazy about entertainment? Every bitch got pregnancy pictures. Even bitches who ain't even famous got a pregnancy pic. Bitch, I'm supposed to believe
Henry benches 350.
I believe it.
Oh shit!
I believe it.
I don't even bench to know if that's a lot or less. I'm
You're
not amazed.
You're supposed to be able to bench your own body weight.
Oh damn!
He knows, you know his body weight's low.
Oh damn! I'm that weak.
You come to that realization because I weigh 145, 150 throughout my life. It always ranges. It's never bigger than that. Never lower than that. When they take me to the gym, nigga, we always working on calisthenics in that bar.
Yep.
With maybe 10 pounds of weight on the 50 pound bar. So that's 60 pound. Oh Jesus Lord.
Bar God.
But I got bars though. Don't battle me though. Lyrically.
Bar God. Big facts.
Yeah.
Security.
So Wendy Williams didn't have like pregnancy pictures, neither did Michelle Obama.
Michelle Obama?
Really?
Drum roll, you're gonna want this.
Oh Jesus, here we go.
Bro, on God.
Let's go.
Y'all don't understand. That's a man. That's a nigga.
Oh my God, no.
Bro. Oh God. Listen.
Oh my God.
Y'all politicians. Y'all ain't did no athletic shit. I didn't look for your shit. We found them kids real parents.
Oh my God.
He gonna get us in trouble in the future.
They gonna get us shut down.
They had surrogates. Why you need a surrogate? If you can't have kids, which is an all moment, which women don't want to touch on that.
You can have eggs implanted inside of you. You didn't have the kids because you got a dick.
Uh-huh.
Have a dick.
This is all new to me. I don't even know.
All you got to think about is
pull up a picture and show them.
All you got to not even just a picture. I want you to go in your memory, my nigga. I want you to go into your memory.
So wait, she don't got no pregnancy pictures?
Bro,
she had surrogates.
She not only has no pregnancy pictures, right? These kids belong to a whole new group. I'm not even on no surrogate. These
Maybe it wasn't flattering. You know what I'm saying? Maybe it wasn't
just
flattering for her.
Implants just to look good, like we let some light skinned niggas into the White House because we not letting Wesley Snipes or his family.
No, we ain't letting
anybody
Wesley.
Darker than you feel me?
Than like, caramel. Oh, God. Caramel is as far as you get.
Caramel. They're not even going caramel.
Have we ever even seen a regular person in the White House?
Caramel
like a motherfucker from the block. Like anybody from a regular neighborhood that grew up in a regular cul-de-sac or something like that, like a regular project, a regular apartment building. Have we ever seen that in the White House ever?
Yeah, we have. I'm gonna tell you what the trick is.
Somebody grew up in an apartment and grew up in the White House.
You want me to tell you what the trick is for that?
Who did that?
Where do you think all the niggas go? We don't just go into the NBA. We don't just go into the NFL. Nigga, if LeBron James is dunking on 50 niggas at a time, I might need that for the CIA. I might need that to get some shit done. And the CIA and any secret organization is a secret. So why would you see niggas protecting the president? You're not supposed to see him.
Mm. Oh, a regular dude. I want to see like Al Bundy as the president. That dude knows some things.
That's
about...
not a regular nigga. That's
Al
Bundy.
I want to see Martin. You know, no, Martin's
been through a lot.
If you want a regular nigga, I want them two crackheads I seen at the side of the building before we came in here. That's a regular motherfucker.
What they gonna eat today? I don't know about that part. But I'm like, look,
they had crackhead love. I know about that part.
You got some testicles to pull this off, bro.
Love don't get the job done. Come on.
This is a nice residential property.
Now that we're back up, we got an HOA. You think Caster is going to get reelected?
Who?
Caster? Nigga, is that the nigga from Cuba?
Yeah, that's why we call her Castro.
Okay, because I was thinking, I thought she was going to say Biden. I had to make sure
my
I knew
my partner's out here. Stupid.
I think anybody that's got some shit going, got their shit going. I'm more worried about. See, this is the problem. You want me to tell you what the real problem with the
let's
world
go.
Is?
Tell us what. Tell us.
The problem is. Niggas don't know how to mind their business no more. And when I say niggas, I mean people. That
people,
is my name now.
People as
people,
in general.
Places, or things. Yes. And now, y'all don't know how to mind y'all business. First of all, we got black on black crime, white on white crime, police brutality, all the shit in America and COVID, right? And GMO, whatever, right? And you telling me about another fucking country and
we ain't got shit right here. You worried
Do you
about
feel me? You worried about the bitch across the street,
Thank
but
you.
Did you vote?
I did. You got dog poop all in your yard, and you worried about the neighbor.
Do you feel me? How you got dog shit in your yard?
With dandelions in his
With grass. Dandelions, and you worried about why he complaining and smells
that
like,
the broke on his side of the manure. Fence. That sound like the broke niggas, like, what's that, that fertilizer? Yeah. That sound like the broke niggas
That's fertilizer, baby.
That's funny. Oh, my God.
That motherfucker's crazy, bro.
Well, I'm a conspiracy
well, that was fun.
Yeah,
really.
I will, don't play.
I did sign her up, though, for Best of the Bays.
Who?
Jane Caster, the mayor.
You signed her up for what?
Caster,
best mayor?
The mayor.
No, I
There's
signed
only one
her
mayor.
For,
you can't be the best mayor.
Best, hold on. It's the worst thing of taxpayers' money. The worst use of taxpayers' money.
No, are you serious?
Yeah, I vote every day.
Why would you do that to her?
Because it's going to be funny as fuck to watch that award.
There's now, listen, first of all, wait.
This is my problem.
Yeah, there's an award for the worst waste of taxpayers' money.
Why not? 1 through 5, my nigga. I strongly disagree.
Tampa. I love Tampa.
What you expect, bro?
We're going to give you an award for being crappy at your job.
Here we come. Is that Henry? Who's showing up?
No, there ain't no. No, he ain't coming.
I heard somebody come in here. Somebody come in here.
Now,
is it Jason?
This is my only problem. See, for now real, we right? don't mind
There's
our
enough
business.
Of us. I think we'd be all right.
And when we mind our business, we out here not helping. Now you voting for her to be the worst. Do you have a friend running? Can we vote for somebody while there is the worst?
There will be a. I mean, not for the category I'm voting
like
for.
Come on, man.
But I'm saying when it comes around to be the mayor again, like for re-election, of course I'm going to vote. Look, of course.
No, but I mean, like we need like. About. See, we know where the bullshit is, and then we always got options. So you're one of those people who have enough. What it is in your body, if drive or whatnot, or curiosity, or you could just be that petty too. Want to be like, bitch, you've been fucking up. I'm going to keep saying strongly disagree. My only thing is, please have one of your friends that, whether it was your ex-boyfriend and fucking doing a Harley with one leg, somebody you know you think could run for mayor and do a good job. So while you strongly disagree, and I need you to be letting them know they should be running before all my options is salt and pepper, and then you just disagreed with salt.
I like Grady Judd.
Oh, I don't like that.
That motherfucker from Polk County that goes out there taking.
You said Polk. I don't even. What is that? You said I'm from Virginia.
Lost me
and
at Polk
I know
County.
Polk ain't it. I know it's not it.
Nah.
Isn't that where Al Bundy graduated from? Polk County?
No, that's
Polk,
the high school Polk he went to. Four touchdowns, one game.
Fictitious characters.
Can't beat that.
Look, who else is running? Look, Kanye West is running for
Bar guy for president.
That's a I would
Bar guy for president. I'm not running for mayor.
Would y'all vote for Kanye? Aww.
First of all, I'm going to tell you some shit. Yes.
You would? I would too.
Oh, God. You're going to give
Trump,
me.
If we got Trump, why can't we have Kanye?
You're going to tell me Electoral College vote?
If we got Arnold Schwarzenegger,
for
why,
Trump?
Can't we
why can't we have Kanye? Oh,
first of
all, why can't we have George Bush hates black people?
You ever had some food?
I miss that.
Kanye is a little unstable. I'd rather vote for The Rock.
Nah, fuck that.
But The Rock ain't running. We would.
I want Kanye to be healthy and happy.
I would love to have Kanye.
Because if.
That
the Rock.
That's what I want for him.
Was
I
actually
on a
vote. That's probably why I ain't seen it because they know we gonna vote for that nigga.
Who?
We know The Rock. Oh. He's literally mixed with black and white. The Rock is him. That's The Rock.
The Rock is sitting over
white.
Here to my
he
left.
He should have shaved before here.
Who's this guy back here? Everybody's watching.
Oh, this is my personal security guard. He actually has his own security business. Word. We got the logos. We got the cars.
Shout
Make
out
sure
the business.
Holla.
What's the business?
Oh, Brandon Security. You already know all day.
He tried to fight me earlier. I put the magic on him.
There you go. Nah, you ain't fighting me no more.
His arms got bound up like that. That's why he ain't moving.
All day. Because I be battle rapping, and he got to hem a nigga up. And the cool thing is, he's got like an anger problem, and I got a talking problem.
There you go.
So usually around the time I've like pissed somebody up.
Those two don't work together.
Bro, that's a wild what happens is, I'll be done battled somebody on the street. Like, what's his name? Mike Mass. We didn't already. Shout out.
No comment.
Look.
I can't say a word.
Battle. Anyway.
That ain't none of my business.
I'm not going to say
I'll
a word.
I'll battle some people on the streets and they'll get aggressive. And usually by the time they ready to get aggressive, he's like angry by
You're
them.
You're not getting aggressive.
He's like angry by them.
You got to have one of those guys though. You have to, because people see him and are like,
why
it ain't that serious.
Why can't Tampa entertainers and people in the business get together?
Because everybody wants to be the man.
Because everybody wants to fight.
No, everybody wants to be the guy.
What Master P did, what E-40 does, what Birdman had done. Why can't we do what these guys did? Because people forget, like, Drake, Birdman. Why can't people come together and create show business.
Now, listen, egos.
Egos.
Let me break it down to you in pussy, because that's all the way I can break it
let's
down.
Let's go,
this
let's
go.
My bars.
So what I've noticed is, I was talking to my girl about this, like, it hits me, but I'm sure it's every nigga. So, we didn't left high school, we done left college. Everybody's got people in the past. You got people you've had crushes on, you got people you talk to, you got this, that, and the third, you got the women you dated. We done left our hometowns. I done at least left my hometown. You might have your hometown people. So you see people from your high school still to this day, 10, 15 years later, 20 years later,
right,
fucking having babies newly with bitches you used to fuck with
exactly
from back in the day.
But in show
did
business,
you have to wait for me to leave?
In show business, are you willing to work with other people too?
Listen.
You have
you
to
work with people?
I'm over here. Think about that. We could have, back in the day, homie, I could have told you she was a hoe back then. And instead of her going to sleep with the other guy, we could have kept it in-house, just like we supposed to keep our showbiz money in-house.
Mm.
I could have told you about that, but nah, you want to act like you're not interested. You want to lie over years and plot when she go get looking like a sloth after years. You could have had her in her prime. Mm. Nah, you want to plot. You want to wait.
Same mm-hmm. thing with the business. Why am I going to work with you if I got the mentality of that same thing? We supposed to keep mm-hmm. that money in-house. Mm-hmm. But I don't want that connect you got. I want that manager you got. I want the radio show you own. I want that. So why would I want to work with you when I want what you have? I don't want to share it. Mm. I don't want a piece of it with you. I want what you have. I want your bitch. Mm. That's the simple.
That's Tampa. How people that's are. Is Tampa. That you or is that people?
That is literally that's, people. For yeah, me, I'm on yeah. the other end like, nigga. Let's, the moment I found out she was a hoe, we could have... I could have passed it on and yeah. I could have looked like that.
I could have went first.
And then could have been
that
like
gave
this.
You a present.
I could have looked like that nigga years later. Hey, bro, remember when I gave you that bitch? Instead of you having to go like sneak around, I could like pretend I was that guy. Remember when she cheated on me secretly and I didn't tell you, so I just threw it to you because I knew she was a hoe? You feel me? No, you had to find out through social media when she throw out that memory. Mm. The fuck out of here. Yep. You got to wait till I leave my connects. You got to wait till I leave Young and May or Lil Wayne alone. You couldn't have worked with me, with him, or these people? Mm. No, that's the main reason. It's an ego, but that's the descriptive
right.
part.
I just look at things like everything is a step at a time, right? Mm-hmm. Like Martin Luther King said, you know, you don't have to see the whole staircase, just make a step. Mm-hmm. So every day I try to make a step in my business, and I try to connect. I try to connect the dots. I try to make sure everybody's going up that same, you know, that same pathway, whatever it is for them that benefits them, benefits everybody around. And I look at around here and I'm like, yo, we got all this talent, we got all these artists, we got everybody. I'm like, I'm not that petty to like hold on to something small. I want to let something go when it comes to the business part. Mm-hmm. When it comes to personally, I don't mind having, you know, feelings hurt or whatever, but it's because it doesn't fuck my money up. Mm-hmm. You understand what I'm saying? Like, let's make the money. Let's get it.
But you're thinking simplicity. You're thinking the simplicity that you're hoping for is the same reason why there isn't world peace or world hunger isn't solved. Mm. It's that same dumbass bitch. They ain't get it then. They not gonna get it now. Mm. So then once you get to that, you just worry about you and the people that are trustworthy or got common sense. Because common sense ain't common. Think about that. You're like, why can't?
Makes sense.
Why can't? I'm asking for $300. You asking for $300. Why can't we come together and get the $500 a piece?
Yeah.
And work
split
with this one
difference.
Guy.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
They don't
yeah.
see that.
Get it
they
done.
Want the
yeah.
whole stack and they don't see the future.
Ah. Yeah.
You
I
feel
guess
me?
That's a lot going on. We talked about it earlier about Tampa. It kind of has that little bit of that going
it's
on.
It's not even just Tampa. It's that y'all spent a lot of time
I
in
feel
Tampa.
Like it's a lot worse.
Well, I'm from
Tampa.
The West Coast.
It's
we
bad
don't,
in Tampa.
We don't do shit like that out there. It's different.
No, West Coast, dude. I love it, bro. Coast. When I was out in the West Coast, that yeah. was one thing I knew is like
people come together.
Nobody beefs like well there's
it's
beef
different.
But it's people different. But if you're just getting into the game and you're just getting into the game and I've been in the game, I'm in the car like, yo, y'all want to freestyle?
Yeah.
And we will ride for an hour and freestyle
and figure it out. Yeah,
but
I'm gonna tell
you just because to have fun with it.
That's different culture.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm.
East Coast is also why now see now,
it's more competitive out here.
West Coast and East Coast, West Coast is friendly. It's more I
don't know about all that.
No. When you say overall, like think about overall, and when I say overall, I'm thinking of how the talents work out. Think about where Biggie came from and Tupac.
Mm-hmm.
Tupac was still about fucking your bitch. But Biggie is literally on the street corner battle rapping you.
Yeah.
Talking shit about you now, here. Where the fuck you at? Tupac will go from Dear Mama to where's the
so Cali's all, well, Cali's all about making music.
Create.
New York is more about the culture, which is the battles, the DJs,
East
the breakers, all
fuck.
Of that.
They aggressive. Right, right.
Yeah, yeah.
So how do you take the aggression and make it art? How do you make it sell? How do you come together? What's the step? What's the move to make it all come together? That's what I want
to
know.
You gotta fuck with yourself and have the sense and ingenuity
love
to do
yourself,
what you're doing now.
Love who you are. Have a sense of
self-esteem. Yeah, people will gravitate towards what you're moving as long as you're doing it for the right reason.
Not even just that. You also gotta... Boom. See, people in your city, just like your parents. Parents are the best example.
Mm.
I have been literally on fucking HBO, did so many random things to where you could gloat to your friends, right? The shit, meet the celebrities, common. You can mention all those people. My mom still ain't seen me fucking perform, bro.
And that's what matters the most.
You feel me? Like,
you know?
My mom that just love. Now seeing the piece.
You gotta have that cosign from the moms.
Yeah. Meanwhile,
what's
I've been...
What's her reason to not, like...
It's just one of those... It's not hate or nothing. It's just that your gift ain't leached into my side of the world. Like, we can know about Chance the Rapper, but your parents that don't fuck with you know about Beyonce and Kanye. Why? And Drake? Because their talent reached they shit. Some people just like that. They gonna be your haters until the bitch they trying to fuck or the manager they trying to be with or the club they wanted to go with fucks with pumping you.
Exactly. You. That's Tampa. You just described Tampa. If you're an artist in Tampa, you're not going to pop in Tampa until Cali shows you love or Europe shows you love. Bro. And then when you come back, guess what? Now your show's sold out.
I was in so many bitches' DMs when I first came down here. I was in so many bitches' DMs, and I got good memory, okay? My girl will be there in a test, and I'll sit there and be like the other day, I knew a bitch head. We got the quarantine. She got the mask on. She bald. I knew a bitch head, her head shape. I said, bitch, don't do that. I was in your DMs when I first dropped the fuck off. Don't do that. Don't try to weigh them titties and that ass in my face and that. Yeah, I was there when I first dropped off. I'm going to go take my light-skinned queen and we going to the crib. Because, bitch, fuck you.
Okay? Exactly.
She was fucking with me before I was hosting shit. Fuck you, bitch.
Yeah, it's funny how things work, man. Big facts.
Safe.
I need that. Yo, I need a replay of that. That was hilarious. We good here.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, man.
Hey, how are you?
How
are you? Welcome to the show.
Oh, thanks.
What's your name again?
Go fuck yourself. I'm just ready for a drink.
Bro, we've been having sidebars
the
whole time. Well, look, this is what we're going
to
do.
You the one that says 7 to 9. Shit.
Well, that's what we normally do.
We got plenty of time. We got plenty of time.
You want to do a car trick?
Let me ask y'all both a question before we go. Let me ask you a question.
And then you get more magic.
Yeah, we'll get more magic.
We need to do a whole. We got to do a whole another.
A round of magic.
Let's do shots. Let's do shots.
Let's do it all.
Let's do shots. I saw you put the bottle up. Let's do shots.
About to be empty though.
But listen, no, that's fine, bro. Listen, that's. Don't worry about that.
Come on now.
I got questions.
Where we at?
You know yourself.
I got questions. So I'm gonna start with you because he's pouring up. I always ask this question. I got my own show that I do, and I like to get in depth, like depth with the artists. So the question I got for you, and I ask, and I'm going to ask you too, so you got time to think about it.
Okay.
What is the very first memory, if you can go as far back as you can go, what's the very first thing you remember about life?
This shit is sad and it's crazy, okay?
No, but a lot of people get made off of their first memory. Most of the time, it's some negative shit.
But for me, since I'm comedic, it didn't really bother me that way. But it's like the most one that I remember that like people don't know that I would remember, right?
Do you know how old you were?
I can tell you that between traveling in Japan at this time, I was between like birth and like fucking before I moved to fifth grade. So it's like a good 11 to 0, 7 to 11 around these years, you know what I'm saying? Like a good memory, but I would really like to say I'm 5, bro.
Okay.
I really want to say I'm fucking 5 because it's one of them weird memories that my parents tell me, but I remember.
You remember, okay.
So when we in Japan, you know how people are. My dad's a pimp, hoe ass nigga, it running the jeans, smooth ass nigga. You feel me? He was in her DMs, like he's checking out for me, but I'm like, bro, is this nigga spitting game or what? I don't know anymore. Bro, this nigga left me at a bus stop in Japan.
No!
Bro, going to... I think this is when he's leaving us as a family in Japan stranded to go fuck with people in the States. Because they're both Navy. But this nigga just left us. He was so scandalous. He would take me to... I remember, like, before then, I'm playing with a Asian kid at some house playing toys and trucks in the hallway. Because he's smashing the Asian woman in the back. You feel me?
But you didn't even know because you...
I specifically remember being chilling with my luggage that I lost like 2 years ago at the bus stop with a teddy bear 2 days after I went on a field trip touching a seal. Like, I remember that.
Damn.
Yeah.
Wow. That's a lot.
Nah, but that's why I like to ask these people these questions you cut to the core of why, what makes you you. Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
That's why beautiful. I'm a sensitive ass.
What about you?
I think I was on my big wheel and I was in a gravel lot. My brother Michael was like, he's my older brother. He's a blood. And he would come around every once in a while.
Now where was this at?
We were in Portland, Oregon.
Okay.
Yeah. And my brother Damien was out in the field somewhere. We had a field next to our house. He grew up. He's a wild boy, man. I was getting pushed on a big wheel. And I'm riding around. I just remember I had to take a shit, and I felt like I came into consciousness at that point. Like I'm like sitting here, like
playing, and I'm like, I know my brothers.
But damn, I got this shit.
And I'm like, I don't know what's going on, but I need to go inside. And there's dust everywhere and shit. We lived in a big brown house.
Yeah.
And so I must have been like 3 or 4 years old. And then after that, from the memories, I woke up. We had a dog named Doc, and Doc used to bite my diaper off. So I didn't have a good. I didn't have adulation.
You don't
for
like
dogs for a long time.
Oh, Dad, that's a horrible memory.
I didn't have no adulation towards dogs until
it's before you even had nerves and they're
for
getting
real.
Like,
yeah, they bite my diaper off. So I moved to Tampa and I realized actually dogs were nice. They're different than they were back because I used to go to Compton all the time, and my aunt and Compton used to have a big ass Rottweiler. And it would smile at you. The dog could smile.
Yeah.
And it was trying to get you to pet him, but he'll bite your fingers off. And my aunt was like,
"That's what happened.
Yo, don't pet that dog, baby." She was like, "That dog would bite you. He's not nice." And I'm like, "He looked nice. He had a smile on and all that. He was drooling."
Do you remember the dog's name?
Nah, I don't remember the dog's name. I don't remember the dog's name, but I remember that moment. So the next moment from the big wheel, I'm riding around 3-4 years old. I need to take a shit. And I realize the dust and my brother's there, so I feel okay. I feel protected. I feel good. And the next memory I had was And Doc was gone. The dog was gone. The stairwell was gone. That he used to run over and get the, you know, do all that. And I was in a foster home. And I didn't know where I was. Then where's my mom? You know what I'm saying? So I had this lady. Her name was Miss Elsie. And when we was bad, she used to grab us by the ear. And she would throw us down.
They don't do that enough nowadays.
She would throw us down the steps.
See, that's a little too far.
So I remember rolling down the steps. And I had to sleep on this like doo-doo stained mattress in the basement. It wasn't like a nice basement. It was a shitty, like all the kids that had been there before was like on that piss stained mattress. Yeah. And it was a trip. And it was like, I want to go home. But it wasn't just, I want to go home. It was like, what the fuck is this? This is not for kids. Like, this is wild. And, you know, shortly after that, I was back with my mom. So, yeah.
That's what's up.
Years
That's
later.
What's
yeah,
up.
Yeah,
yeah. Yo, okay.
You taking the five? That's for, look. That's for the legs.
Hey,
that's for the prosthetics.
Crazy, man. Hey, first of all, if $5 is going to get you your toe, can you bend your toe? Well, that was the $5 I sent.
Put that towards the prosthetics.
In between the titties. That's what I'm supporting. Come prosthetic on, titties. Ladies, if you lost your titties due to cancer, sitting all day out in the sun because some bitch told you skin tone and melanin matters, which it does, but hey, I didn't tell you to go tanning. Anyway, if you lost your titties to some sad shit, I'm donating $50 off top.
Let's go.
$50 just so you can get your nipple back. Nipple back. Nipple back. Oh, areola.
Oh, my God.
Sad
These
thing.
Ain't even got no nipples on them.
Yo, that I'm down to make a remix.
That's the trick.
Hey, listen.
Remix.
Far away. Yo, salute.
I'm
do the card trick real quick. We're going to close out with some bars.
Yo, shout out to my guy. All right,
so I handed you a deck of cards. You took the plastic off of it.
Plastic's right there.
I want you to just open the deck up. Just make sure. Let me show you how to do it. You stick your thumbnail off.
No, I don't even want to deal with this right now. Because last time y'all got me fucked.
You got it.
I just can't shuffle.
Do it over the table.
Okay.
If you can't shuffle, do it over the table. There's 52 cards in there plus two jokers plus two advertisement cards. So take the advertisement cards out. Take the jokers out. You can put them over the table. Put these shits to the side.
Oh, Lord. What's he doing?
Just look through them. Is that
There's only one advertisement card.
Nothing square. Nothing. There's a square deck. Nothing weird about them. Nothing too strange.
No, there's only one advertisement card, though.
I got to watch this.
There's not two?
There's only one.
Should be two. There's usually two.
Usually there's two.
Cards. It's like a how to play the game.
See any advertisement cards in there?
All right, you got it. Just make sure you mix them up.
Look, if I... Once I took that,
you
nigga,
can look at
they friends, nigga. They friends.
Can we see it on the TV here? Put them up right here, and then just mix them up any way you want.
Okay.
Just shuffle them up. You could mix them up. Just make sure it's in no particular order.
I'm still stumped on how you did adulation. That's crazy, bro. All
right. So, do you want me to mix it up to make sure it's a little bit further? Okay, good. Let me know when you're ready.
Do it the old fucking little
kid. She got
it.
She got it. She got it.
And then I'll just cut it a couple times.
You got it? You doing it. She's mixing them cards up like a real pro. Look
big facts.
I already know this.
The casino, Hard Rock Casino.
I'm trying to make sure that there's nothing nefarious going on right here.
Observe.
To take away from the innocence of the magic.
Henry, you're missing another magic trick.
Yo, Henry's a punk.
I thought he was going to be here. I thought you were going to show up, Henry, on us. All right, so I want. Are you happy with that? All right, so here's what I want you to do. I'm just going to
take a look at how well you did. You actually did pretty good on this. You did pretty good.
Did real good.
All right. Do you have any, just at a weird question, do you have a card in mind that is just at random?
I can put one in my mind. I just did right now.
What's the first card that comes to mind?
First, do I want me to say it?
Yeah.
Three of spades.
Three of spades. Okay. Are you happy with that or do you want to?
That's fine.
You like three of spades?
I just like antagonizing.
There you go. Okay. I swear to God.
Reach out and touch a card.
Take
a look at it, memorize it. You got to look at it. Pull it out. It's not the three spaces.
No, it better not be.
That would freak me out if it was.
It would be because
that would freak me out. Let's go. Make sure the camera can see it and everybody else.
Camera's right here. You put it right there.
See it, okay?
Keep going.
Everybody sees it.
Keep, no, put face it in the camera.
Happy with that?
Keep going. Boom, I got it. We see it. Good.
All right. You happy with that card?
Yeah.
You don't want
to look
your mind?
Like no. David Blaine as a Muslim.
For real, right?
All right. Allie, I'm just going to run my finger like this. You tell me where to stop, anywhere you want.
Stop.
Right there.
Okay.
Place your card there. Thank you so much. You were happy with your card. You could have picked any card whatsoever.
Let's go.
Yeah? Mm-hmm. And it was.
Man, get the drum rolls ready. Get this shit ready.
Sergio's going to freak out and start yelling again.
Fuck that. So that's adulation is completely
different. Here's what magicians do all the time. They'll have you pick out a card. They'll shuffle the cards. The cards will be mixed up, whatever like that. And then what ends up happening is they find the card. Right? So it's not really anything that magical about that because each card has a different significance to it. There's 52 cards in a deck. There's 52 weeks in a year. There are four suits in a deck. There are four seasons in a year. The Joker represents the text message that you're getting right now to check over the statement that I'm making.
I swear to God. If you got a text message.
And when you look away, I've already found your card. So this is what happens. People, they don't pay attention.
Found my card.
That's your card?
But it's not about just your card. Here's what it's about. He said three of spades.
I swear to God.
I'm going to change it. Right? Just take a look and make sure that there's nothing weird about that. Yes? Make sure.
There's nothing weird about that popping up.
All these cards are different, right? Look, all the difference. Yeah, all the difference in the world.
They're all different, yeah. The brand new deck.
Here's what's weird about that. The three of spades is underneath your seat right now.
Whose seat?
Yours.
I swear to God.
I'm just kidding.
I was about to say, bro. Don't play
Nobody
with me.
Oh, God.
I would have left.
We all was about to be fucked up in the head. I'm about to be like, this nigga plotted from the beginning.
But when you look away, you always miss the idea that the card could change at any moment. And she looked away twice. I just heard
Is that
the ace
of spades?
That's
the three of spades.
Three of spades. It's his card. So watch a three disappear. Watch one, two, gone. And you check the box, make sure it's not in there.
I swear to God.
Why you got to make sure I see you go back in the box?
Oh, no, there is another advertisement card, though.
There's no three of spades in this deck. No, there's no three of spades in the deck whatsoever. There's a four of clubs. There's a two of spades.
It's on your head.
It is on my head, isn't it? You missed it.
Everybody is retarded.
Yeah, you looked away.
Your neck is dirty. You amazed a little bit, ain't you? Look.
So now that I get you to pay attention.
Okay, let's go.
This is the whole warm-up here.
That's a warm-up.
And I want you to make sure that those cards are also mixed up again. I mixed them up.
What's your Cash App? What's your Cash App?
I don't even know. I have no idea. I'm on
Antwan Towner.
There you go.
Cash App.
Somewhere, right?
Real Bar God.
All right, so the cards are mixed up, right?
Yep.
Check it out. All right, you happy with that?
Yeah, sure.
All right, so BarGod, I want to have you participate on this one.
You better ask my
You don't have to do anything too strange.
I'm checking under my chair right now.
You happy?
Strange. Is there something
Sergio's
you
checking just underneath the chair.
All you have to do is reach out and touch any card you want. But just reach out and touch one with your finger.
I was
somebody's car.
You're gonna miss it all.
Yeah, you mixed them up though, right?
Yeah.
Just reach out and touch one. Take a look at it.
I'm looking at nothing. I'm taking it right here where I'm at.
You got to look
your
at
age,
it.
Your age that you said when you said the story that you told earlier. How old was he?
I don't remember.
I remember.
How old was
he
it?
Said he
what did
he was
I say?
Five.
I said five. There you go.
That should be a five. And you are a diamond. You shine
hard. Damn!
Oh, are you serious?
Yo! This nigga was not supposed to get that. He was not supposed to get that.
AntwanTowner.com.
How?
And everybody in here is next. And I did a drunk point. I did that. Hopefully, did I fuck up your trick? I moved too fast.
How did you do that?
That's what I'm saying. Reach out and
touch some. Man, listen.
I can't sing. I would go with
I
y'all.
Can't do this. I can't do this.
We ain't got it. Man, it's 2020. Don't nobody know
and
how
this,
to sing.
This deck of cards, this is for you to keep because I don't use trick decks.
Word. Okay.
These are for y'all to show anybody that has a question about it. You know, a lot of times when I was younger, I used to use, you know, I worked at a magic stop, so we had all kinds of stuff.
My security guard looks so damn confused, bro.
Those are yours to keep.
This nigga look like.
This one over here.
Oh, God, this nigga's like.
You like you got him angry again. Like
I saw you guys focusing right here, and I looked at Sergio, and I pointed.
I was just trying to see who was paying attention. So that's the thing. Sometimes we do that. And he does that with his claps. You be I see you throw stuff. Yeah, just to see if you heard it. He rapped something the other day, and he said they need to catch up. And then he says, "I'm not even relish for my." And I was like, "How did he even do that part?" Like I was on the, I was like, "Catch up, relish." I'm like,
"Common
yo.
Bars."
But
y'all
I
know what I'm talking about.
It was. Bro, I was paying attention. That's all I wanted to say.
I'm still done at the. I did a drunk point, y'all. You know the drunk point
where you try to trick them.
No, not even try to trick them. Just like you move before they like really finish their sentence. Nigga wasn't even done, and I'm like. He's still spreading the cards. And he's like, "Are you sure?" And I'm like, "Damn.
Yeah, got it.
Did I fuck his shit up by moving too fast?
Why did I probably wasn't even looking?"
Then he started asking questions that was specific. I was like, "God damn it. You might not even want to mention five. I might fuck his shit up. God damn it. Man, throw him one beat so we can close this shit out.
All right, let's
do
go.
That. Let's get it in right now.
We going to get fucked up after this. Make sure you get Antwan Towner on your Facebook. Follow Real Bar Guy, Real _ Bar Guy on Instagram, on any platform. Also got the motherfucking shit that I host. These the motherfucking people that you might want to follow.
Go!
You know what you got. I swear I should just be on the radio. Like Luda Lovell.
First of all, I want to put my baby on something. I'm not rapping to this. Yeah. Find another one. Remember I asked you about Fight Night with Roy Jones?
Yeah. That's my favorite.
This is literally
it is.
Oh, it goes to the intro to yeah. this game. And yep. I refuse to rap to some Roy Jones.
Why?
Two levels above you, baby. Above you, baby.
I'm going to make you love me, baby.
Got it. Snap back to reality. Oh,
nigga, who the have any? Oh. Let's go. Do you want to? Nah.
Man, I'm going to do this, but I want some hot shit.
All right.
Maybe on a plot shit. Put me on a Tetris with a cube. I mean block shit. Never with a girl who's still texting. I could block shit. She ain't got to tell me too much. You know I'm on top shit. That'll be Jenga. You know I'm a ringer. Bugs with a fucking bunny. She knows that I'm fucking stinker. I'm going to have to pick her up. More like Jakina. She going to tell me exactly what I need before I ring her up. Daily, open her like I be Dave Chappelle. I never been the rebel, but I tell her that I'm here prevail. Are we gonna watch the fight of Mike Tyson ropes this nigga? I mean, against whatever ropes this nigga. I mean, whatever gotta choke this nigga. I mean, nigga get choked, but the throat is nigga. I mean, tell me what you like before your VCR become a DVD before I CDR. 5G without a stream with a cayman attached. I don't like the beat, but right now it's a flame attached. She can tell me that we old school. Nigga gotta change up the beat and his vocal cords just to get a pick up the heat. I'll infiltrate cities and city wise with a titty. Looking up for a thought, you know I'm giving out pennies. Two nickels get a dime, I notice she looking pretty. Sitting with a nigga whose mind is clever, I mean witty. Still bat like a gym rat. We just wanna do what is combatant. Fatality a combatant. Still in my reality, nothing with a portion. But my portal got a mortal. Mortal combat that I judge you. And I tell you that I'm cool. Fast forward, I need shots. I mean shots. I done drank the Crown Royal off the block. I mean really off the top. And she gotta say stop. I've been fighting inside an octagon. They couldn't really watch. Oh,
that's my man.
No, man, give me another one, cause that's for you. That was childhood.
Alright, let's go.
Do you have like a new school beat? Because that's how I've been rapping for.
I got a lot of old
school. Man, I'm going to tell you something. If you want old school, then you have to put up an old school beat where they spit bars across it. Not made a good song, but spit bars across it. Because then you got to give me like a Big L, Cassidy, Biggie. These are the Braves. I don't know.
Let's see what we got.
Juel Santana, Young Bloods. Remember them niggas?
Big facts.
Yeah, bro. I'm just saying, those niggas have bars. Matter of fact, we're Andre 3 Stacks and fucking Outkast and them. If you want bars, am I supposed to be talking about punching gloves in a fight with a punchline, but my line got a punch? She say it's the time, well, it's the time for the lunch or crunch. Such and such, that came with a sit up. I just mentioned crunch. You get it? That comes with a sit up. It was a magic trick bar.
He's stupid.
You had to go forward just to come back. Ah, you ain't got another beat.
All right, let me see. What I got. I'll give you some.
Oh, it's past it. Oh, okay.
You want some of that?
Yeah, I'll close
let's
it
go,
out.
Let's go, let's go, let's
quick.
Go.
Do y'all do like an ending thing or something?
No, we just hanging out.
Okay. I want all of y'all to notice, when I murder this, he chose an Outkast beat, but what is he doing on this? Still not bars, right? Don't he sing? My baby don't mess with. Okay, I just want everybody to realize.
Let's go.
What I'm about to fuck with.
It sound like country. What do you listen to?
Turn it up a little bit. When my baby don't mess around because she loves to cry, she gotta fuck with me. Still high like a canopy, but if she loves me, she gotta suck on me. Never dynamite, I came with my protractor in a lab like a labyrinth. I never had a ladder, but I elaborate for days and on a ladder saying she may still mayday like it be melee. Payday with a cost before I'm lost. Before she talks, she tell me that I be a boss. Just like Bowser, it's a browser like I'm searching on Safari. I'm cool without my jungle, take an iPhone if you want me. They say that we be battling, no drug, but this ain't robot, it be Will Smith and entanglement. Next month be some August shit, I ain't even done with it. She just wanna jogging it. I know my vicinity is renting with a cubic metric. She just wanna know that I be moving through the heavens hectic. That's just me on a microscopic level. I dig that pussy, I might need a fucking shovel. Levy, I mean Chevy, if she heavy, I might break. She wanna say a figure eight, get that pussy, then I skate. Okay.
That was dope as fuck.
Always.
Oh my God. Lord.
They needed some bars for them. They were like, But yeah, we'll let y'all close out so we can all make our.
All right. Well, this is music still playing? Am I good?
Yeah, you good. Go ahead. Okay. Talk your shit. Talk your
Well,
shit.
This is the end of Breasts and Thighs. Thank you, Henry, for not joining us. You
wow.
All the magic
wow.
Tricks.
You can put him on blast like that?
We're going to have to do it against Hard wow. Here.
Thank you, BarGod
wow.
And Antwan and Security.
AKA Twan.
What's happening? Tell them, you know, we got to do this again, man. Come on.
I mean, we're going to do
oh,
it.
I'm with
Henry
it.
Henry better be here next time.
I'm we still, got three. We got two
we'll
more
sign,
times.
We'll sign contracts.
I'll show some real magic next time.
We'll sign contracts.
You said I'm battling a URL nigga.
I'll quit playing around. I'll do the real stuff next time.
Okay.
Is he
well, we can also get that whack nigga up here. Listen, if you want some money, we can battle. Just like I would love to see you battle the magician. I don't know if they do that. I haven't seen a movie about that.
I don't
that.
Think there's a mute.
We just make money together.
I don't I'd think love they can do that. That. Yeah.
But
they're not
like,
about that.
Like BarGod just
Y'all
said,
work.
I want to give
but
a
Gordon,
shout out
up
to
here.
The
you
URL. Blue Easy,
yeah,
Smack, Charlie Clips. You know, those are my three favorites.
Charlie, the only nigga that can handle me. Charlie, the only nigga that can handle me.
I think Blue Easy could take you.
No. Blue Easy would get with writtens, and I could do the writtens, but when I talk about the microphone being too close to your face, like the Glock 9 is too close to my waist, who's gonna like literally bring
oh,
up
you
the
watch that video? That was a dope video.
Bro, I didn't, but that means we got more magic tricks. Do you hear me? Like, Louise got good writtens, but Charlie's the only nigga that does freestyle.
Well, he lives
here. Well, you know who to hit up.
Alright, well, we will see you next week. Hopefully my co-host will decide to join us.
Wow!
Yeah.
Shots at Henry all.
Dang. Shout out to the White Lie that we are about to go spend our money at. So
hopefully
we will
we'll get it.
Is that where you're going now?
The new money.
Yeah.
We will see.
White Lie, Mo. Hey, Henry need to walk up here next time.
Whoa,
Henry, you going to walk
shit.
Up to the studio, buddy?
It is brutal
we love
in
you,
here.
Henry. We love you, Henry. We love you.
All right. So we'll see you guys next week. Let's close this out. Thank you for joining us. And we're done.
All right.
Big facts.
West Coast.
Y'all already know who it is. Tune in tomorrow. We're going to be right. All right, y'all already know what it is. Y'all already know what it is. Breasts and thighs. Tune it off. Tomorrow we got what's really going on. Wednesday we got just chilling. Thursday we got I forgot. Wait, Wasted Wisdom Thursday. Friday we got Gen TV. Saturday we got a full calendar. Thank y'all for tuning in. You already know what it is.
nothing, it's nothing, it's nothing, it's nothing, it's nothing, it's nothing, it's nothing. Nothing. Stack of cheese to my bread, right? Smoke a weed to my head, right? Did it all on my own, so I'ma spend on my bread like it's nothing. Stack of cheese to my bread, right? Smoke of trees to my head, right? Did it all on my own, so I'ma spend on my bread like it's nothing. Trees to my head, right? Did it all on my own, so I'ma spend on my bread like